North Carolina A&T Aggies face the daunting task of containing Florida A&M receiver Jacque Nunley, who is on the verge of breaking Jerry Rice's career receiving record of 301 receptions. The Rattlers, still reeling from a tough loss to Grambling, have to kickstart the high-octane Gulf Coast offense that stalled. Put your tray tables forward and the seat backs in the upright positions. We are about to experience some turbulence as two Titans clash on MEAC College Football Saturday.
There are palm trees in Tallahassee. The weather is right for football, but it's definitely going to heat up this game. North Carolina A&T, the Aggies, taking on Florida A&M. Yes, it's tailgating. Yes, that's an appetizer, because the full menu is yummy for your tummy. One of the best college football games on the schedule this weekend, and it's all part of MEAC College Football Saturday. Hello, everybody. I'm Ronnie Duncan. This is Countdown to the Showdown. Two undefeated teams in the MEAC. 4-0 BAMU, 2-0 North Carolina A&T. Both have lost one game outside the conference, but both are about to explode in this game. One guy is going to light the fuse. He's Mark Gray.
Well, I tell you, if you're not pumped for this game, I got some dynamite, and I'll stick it down on the shores to blow you up. You got two teams at the top of their conference. They're nationally ranked. They're battling for the conference supremacy as well as national notoriety. It really don't get no better than this.
You know, you're talking two teams. Opposites do attract. One known for its defense, the Blue Death defense of North Carolina A&T, giving up just 8 points a game, and one of the guys anchoring that defense, number 38, B.J. Little, and he's not little when he talks football.
Boy, I tell you, number 38 is simply a beast. That's what they call him in Greensboro. He gets after you in run support. He gets after you as he does right here on the blitz. You know, Ali Culpepper from Morgan, new number 38 after last Saturday. I'm sure he's still having visions of B.J. This guy does it all. He leads the team in tackles. He's aggressive in terms of going after the quarterback. You really can't ask for any more at this level from a linebacker who does it both in run support and in pass coverage than B.J. Little. He is a beast.
I tell you what, the MEAC has had his hands full of Jacque Nunley, number 85. He's the talented wide receiver for the FAMU Rattlers. And the reason why he's talented, he's knocking on the door of records, and Jerry Rice is the man he's got targeted. He's only 30 catches away.
And he can take it to the house. This is him getting deep against Delaware State. Then you'll see him coming up in just a little bit right here, taking a nice little short corner pass in the corner of the end zone. And he is most dangerous at running after the catch. This is a kid that when you talk about leading your team by example, he has 50 receptions coming into this ball game. Do you know the next person on the FAMU receiving list has only 18? Nunley is the man. He's got a trading card. He's on the front page of the sports section. You got to be pretty large in Tallahassee on the day Florida State is having homecoming to have your face on the front page of the Tallahassee Democrat.
I can tell you this much. They are now campaigning this young man for a Heisman. And you know what? He could get it. You just never know. Now let's take a look at the quarterbacks, because Jason Battle is the man for North Carolina A&T. You know what? They've got like a three-headed, two-headed quarterback monster down there, but this young man has come up large.
And we'll see some of Keith Matkins as well, but the bottom line is the quarterback in the A&T offensive scheme simply has to manage the field, not make mistakes, and take advantage of the opportunities that the defense is designed to give him. And you know something? This is an aggressive defense that has to try to shut down a very talented FAMU quarterback as well.
How about that? That's Quinn Gray. Last week, he did not perform very well in a losing effort to Grambling, but Quinn Gray is the type of quarterback, not only can he carry the ball, and he's a big guy, but man, his arm is something to be seen.
He can throw all the passes, your prototype drop-back passer, but the thing I admire most about this guy, aside from the fact that it's Gray with an A, of course, the bottom line is he's a leader, man. He had to live all during the offseason with the hurt of throwing an interception in the 1AA playoffs where fam thought they could play in the national championship game. He threw three interceptions after 200 passes last week. He's hurting. I expect a big game for him.
All right, it's time to shake, rattle, and roll. We will MEAC you later.
Hello, I'm Charles Harris, Commissioner of the Mideastern Athletics Conference. On behalf of our 3,000 student athletes, our 200,000 alumni, and our 11 member institutions, I'm delighted you've joined us for this telecast. The MEAC is committed to and plays a leadership role in providing high-quality competitive opportunities and experiences for all of our students. Visit our website at meacsports.com to follow your favorite teams, to learn more about us or our member institutions. Thank you.
MEAC Saturdays 2000 is sponsored in part by USPS, Nike, Xerox, Target, Coca-Cola, U.S. Marine Corps, New Urban Entertainment, Greyhound, Winnower, National Car Rental, and U.S. Airways.
This is the game we've been waiting for. North Carolina A&T and FAMU. Now let's go down to the sidelines with our sideline reporter, Jeff Rutland, with Coach Hayes.
Thanks, guys. Coach Hayes, number one versus number two. This is the MEAC game of the year thus far. What did you tell your guys coming in preparation for today's game?
Well, first of all, we've got to be really disciplined and play very, very aggressive. So put the two together, super disciplined on the field, play arrow-free ball, and be real aggressive. We've got a real good chance today. Thank you.
Coach, word on the street is you've held something back in your offense. Hey, guys, I guess Coach has held something back in his offense, and he's going to show us what's up on the field today. Back upstairs to you guys.
Coach Bill Hayes, you know he has over 90 wins. He's the first coach ever in the history of North Carolina A&T to ever have 11-win season. That was last season when they won the National Black Championship, the MEAC. And, of course, they went to the playoffs and presented themselves extremely well as FAMU. This is going to be a great game. You know, he's so intense. A lot of people look at that situation and go, did he just walk away from the reporter? He did. But well, you know what? If Bill Hayes could still play today, he'd be out there.
That's just what you call having your game face on. He had his game face on when he got off the plane and they got here. A&T has come down here on a mission. They are focused. They are confident. They seem to think they have the key to stopping the West Coast, the Gulf Coast offense, and it is a gorgeous day for football.
How about it? 82 degrees, sunny. The wind is light, and the Aggies of North Carolina A&T will be receiving on the kickoff. We'll get a chance to see number one, Ramondo North, a young man who is by far one of the best at this part of the game in the MEAC.
And one thing about Florida A&M, you know, you talk to people down here. It was true last week's loss to Grambling was the first loss of the season, but down here you would have thought it was almost the end of the world because it is so important how big college football is down here. And let's be real for a second, folks. I know it's homecoming day for Florida State and Tallahassee, and that's a wonderful thing. This is where college football was born, in the state of Florida. Before there was Bobby Bowden in Tallahassee and Burt Reynolds at the University of Florida, Jake Gaither was kicking big-time butt here in Bragg Stadium, and Florida A&M lives today to try to begin anew.
Doing the kicking will be Chad Elstein. We're about ready to get ready for a game that has been much anticipated. North Carolina A&T and the Rattlers of FAMU. Ryan Duncan, Mark Gray, and Rumbling on the sideline, and the kick is off. Ramondo North gets it. North across 20. North finally brought down at the 30-yard line. Now it's time to take a look at our USPS starting lineups, and you see right there what an offensive line. Mr. Mitchell was a freshman, but he played every game, and now he's a sophomore, and they say NFL folks are looking at him already.
6'3", 315 pounds already. Hicks comes in after a huge game last week.
183 yards and two touchdowns on 17 carries. And of course, when you look at the quarterback situation for this offense, there he is, number 14, missed the battle.
Just about a 50% passer, but again, he won't be expected to win the game, just not lose it.
That time was Maurice Hicks. Now let's take a look at that defense for FAMU, and Mr. Daly will be a roving reporter today. He's the end, but this kid can play.
We got him at right end. He'll line up left end. They'll be hiding him throughout the defense all afternoon.
Another part of that defense is when you look at the middle, and there is Burrows. I like him, especially Cola and Brooks.
Coming off of a knee injury last year, and of course, Troy Hart, the converted wide receiver, already has four picks this year, and he's taken one to the house.
Second down situation. The ball was incomplete. That was Ship missing the ball there.
Well, they tried to get him going early, trying to get battle with a safe slant pattern, and it goes off of his fingertips, picking on Hart. Hart, as I said, a converted wide receiver who has been frankly sitting on the bench here in Tallahassee for a couple of years, wanted to get into the lineup. He has replaced Neil Colsey at that cornerback position. Colsey, of course, the son of the former Miami Dolphin great as well.
Marcus Bryson is in the game, number 88. That's the fine tight end for the Aggies of North Carolina. Lone backfield, third and eight. Battle is brought down And once again, the defense all over it. Cola, and that time, it wasn't a Pepsi Cola.
Well, you know something? It looks like somebody blew an assignment on the interior because he comes unaided through the line. And there's nobody who picks him up. Little delayed stunt. He just blasts through the hole, and Cole picks up the big sack. So a great start for the Florida A&M defense, and a much improved defense, I might add, over last season.
Isaac Brown set to receive. And that wasn't the greatest punt in the world, but they will down it at the 50-yard line. So far, this game is living up to the hype, the nervousness, the tension.
I'll exchange it.
Introducing e-merchandise return from the United States Postal Service. It's so simple. Your customers can print a prepaid return label right from your website. Now the stuff they buy online practically returns itself. Easier exchanges for them means more business for you. What's your priority?
Fly like an eagle.
To use your Target gift card. It's the only credit card that donates 1% of your purchase to the school of your choice. Use the Target gift card.
U.S.
The only card that gives back to your favorite school.
All right, Carolina A&T and FAMU, and now it's time to look at that Rattler Gulf Coast offense. And obviously, when you look at these individuals, once they're beaten, they get a streak going. I'm talking the Rattlers losing, of course, to Grambling at the Circle City Classic last weekend. Out of the shotgun formation. And that, of course, was your quarterback, Quinn Gray. The reception was to Isaac Brown. Now let's take a look at our USPS offensive lineups for the Rattlers. And look at that. What an offensive line. Moat has come back, but Derek Gay is so good. OBJ Marchbrank has been a young man who has come on huge for them with Lourdes out of the game. Give the Marchbrank, and Marchbrank takes it down for a first down, and FAMU is off and rolling.
The big talk in Tallahassee this week was about Billy Joe calling more of the plays. There was some concern about Florida A&M play selection when Quinn Gray was calling the plays last weekend, and a nice mix to start by the Rattlers.
Marchbrank, but this time he's brought down Sammy Rogers on the tackle, number 41. Now let's take a look at that United States Postal starting defense and Leonard Relaford. This young man had 3 sacks last week. Sammy Rogers had 3 sacks as well.
That's part
of
9.
Both of these young men compared, put together 6 sacks, of course 9 for the team. Pittman also out there in the secondary. Reception made by T.J. Hines. This young man is averaging 14 yards a catch. And that's more than what Jacque Nunley is getting.
Indeed. Now let's watch him right here. This is nothing fancy about what he's doing. They're just mixing up the plays, a little short stuff, not as aggressive as I'm sure they would like to. This is designed to keep those blitzing linebackers balanced. And there you see right there, honey, the aggressiveness of the A&T linebackers coming on a straight run blitz to stop Mr. Marchbanks behind the line of scrimmage. And there's my man, Ray Massey.
Ray Massey and Sammy Rogers both in on the tackle. They call it the Blue Death Defense, and this time, Marchbrank's almost went to the body back.
If he's not careful, it takes a few more shots like that. Blue Death is going to bring rigor mortis into Bragg Stadium. An aggressive blitzing defense. So we saw Florida A&M try to keep A&T off balance, but the Aggie defensive coaches guessed right in that situation.
T.J. Smith doing the punting. And we've got a flag. Or a whistle being blown. Officials for the day from the MEAC are Fleming Williams, Dwight Pettiford, Colin Curley, Nimmons, Avery Fields, Keith Norman, and Jeff Leaf.
FAMU assessed for a delayed game penalty, Ronnie.
Third down.
And that was, of course, Mr. Lemon Williams, our head referee today.
This is a tremendous atmosphere for college football. Unbelievable.
And once again, more flags on the play. And you see Daly is making sure he exerts a little energy out there.
Well, it's getting a little messy. It's getting a little testy already. You know, two great defensive performers in this conference, but like Coach Hayes was talking about in the open, Ronnie, it's all about discipline, controlling and harnessing the aggressiveness and the emotion. And as you can see, it is getting crunk here in Bragg Stadium in Tallahassee. And for those of you who are cool and paired, I mean that the enthusiasm is brewing.
Mark, the thing you knew about this game is that the tensions would be high. Maybe an indication was that first interview that Rumlin did with Coach Hayes. He wanted to do one thing, answer one question, and one question only. T.J. Smith, once again, doing the punting duties. Young man is averaging 41 yards a punt. This one go deep, and they're going to have to spot this one at the 20.
Well, they tried to give him 5 extra yards in order for him to go for the coffin corner, and Smith just misses.
Once again, our game officials, you see him there, Williams, Pettiford, Coleman, Nimmons, Lee, Keith Norman, and Avery Fields is your side judge.
I would not want to be in Mr. Pettiford's shoes today. When you're the umpire, you're looking right into the teeth of guys like Haley, who will be aggressively going at the quarterback, Burroughs, Massey, Little. I mean, boy, he's going to earn his meal money today.
Jason Battle, your quarterback. Max in the backfield. Give us a Maurice Hicks. And Hicks is able to turn it off to a little something, gaining around 8 yards on the play.
Boy, Andy's big nasties up front do a good job of pulling and a seal to the inside, which create a lane for Hicks to just take it up in there. See, look, these guys are coming straight sweep. He finds the hole, a trap on the inside, taking it up and almost picking a first down up. So a good offensive start to this drive by A&T, who wants to establish the run game. Everything with their offensive flow spins off of the effectiveness of their run game.
Second and two from the 28-yard line. Hicks again, this time Hicks across the field. Hicks across the 50, Hicks at the 40, Hicks at the 30-yard line, Hicks at the 10-yard line, finally taken out. You talk about a tremendous run. That was Tarvius Turner finally bringing it down, but Hicks was trying to make it in zone.
Boy, you couldn't ask for a greater start. Look at the big nephews up front. A great hole in between the A and the B guys, and he just, on individual effort, gets into the secondary, dances to the far sideline, and it becomes a foot race. So A&T starts tremendous, and early on, the offensive game of A&T blasts Florida A&M up front. They're quick and athletic in the line, but they're not that big. A&T has a size advantage, right?
Ball at the 12-yard line. This time, the defense was there. Find him on the stop.
Boy, I tell you, that was a great job that time of playing off a block and just shooting hole in order to make that play. Boy, I tell you, somebody just played off a block, shot through the gap, and was able to stop the running back that time. Great, great play that time by the Aggies. Second and 10 down here. As I said before, Ronnie, Florida A&M's defense will beat you with quick. They're not going to overpower you. This is where A&T really wants to bloody their nose, if you will.
Second and 12. Once again, the Aggies trying to run the ball. That was Adrian Parks on the carry. Bynum on the stop along with Dan.
And we talked about situation substitutes at the quarterback position. There's a nice little rotation of four running backs. Parks sometimes starts. This time he was trying to get something started by going off tackle. And so this is a big play, a huge play for the Florida A&M defense. Big third down situation, deep their own territory. A&T, if they want to pull the upset, has got to think about six.
Third and eight. Battle brought down by
And I think Florida A&M got it.
Yes, it does. It belongs to the Rattlers. And that was number one. Mr.
Stu Daly.
Aggressiveness off the blitz, confusion by the quarterback, and it was a recipe for disaster. Florida A&M takes over, and yeah, Mr. Daly, you earned the right to party after that one. Johnny on the spot making a big-time stick on Battle, and then his teammate Johnny on the spot to pick him up. Daly coming off, playing off a block, and blasting Battle. Rips the ball loose, and it is recovered. Florida A&M dodges a huge bullet early.
It's with the recovery, and once again, we get a chance to see that Gulf Coast offense. And there he is, Quinn Gray. He is your quarterback. Just a lone backfield. Four wide receivers in the game. Gray flushed out of the pocket. And Gray for the football, and it's picked up by
A&T.
A&T picks it up. Sammy Rogers,
you know,
on the recovery.
We talked about the aggressive nature in the open of A&T blitzing. It is a 44 scheme where guys who are in the middle, which is what Massey and Little are doing, and he comes unabated, Gray's in trouble, and he got Pete Cleaver out to strip the ball away, and Winder's right there to pick it up. What a great job by Little, coming off a blitz, unabated to the quarterback, getting the strip, knocking the ball loose, and now A&T has a golden scoring opportunity once again. So Bill Hayes, with his game face on in our open, certainly must have gotten that intensity across to his defensive unit. They are really getting after it early.
This is a great football game, and you're seeing it in the making. Battle is your quarterback. Lone in the backfield, the six. Touchdown, North Carolina A&T.
And when you're a runner-oriented team, that play fake is going to freeze the linebackers, and they left the back in the flat. Hicks takes it in.
Dominique Williams was the receiver, and he takes it in. Touchdown for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. Mark, Coach Hayes isn't playing around today.
Well, we knew coming in that the Aggies were going to open up their offense, and that's basically what they do. When you're a runner-oriented team, the guys in the middle are going to definitely at least look at the play-action fake. The pressure of the pursuit is drawn to the middle. It left the back out there in the flat. He picks up four.
Darren Dawkins with the point there. It is good. It's 7-0. North Carolina A&T coming into the hostile territories of Bragg Stadium, and they take the lead on a touchdown pass. We'll come back with much more as we shake, rattle, and roll.
Whether you're at home conquering the world, venturing out into it, or just taking a break from it, there's a whole new way to stay connected to it. Because Verizon is giving local customers who sign up for select digital wireless plans free internet access at home on their wireless phones until Memorial Day 2001. It's internet how, where, and when you want it. Call Verizon now to find out how you can get it all. Then consider it done.
That's Paul. He's a little indisposed right now. Or he'd be singing the praises of advertising on cable television himself. He'd tell you how he got his phone number out in front of the people who really need somebody like Paul the Plumber.
Anybody missing a bear?
Cable advertising. It's easy, it's affordable, it works. AT&T Media Services. Get your ad worth.
Channel is brought to you by AT&T Broadband.
All right, we're back to live action. North Carolina A&T has taken the lead, 7-0. Battle with a nice touchdown pass to Williams. Let's look at our National Car Rental scoring drive. And Mark Gray, this was play action at its best.
Well, this set up, we have a big run play on the previous drive. It brought people to the center field. And on the previous drive, Hicks was able to break it off and give A&T an opportunity to score. So you come back on the next drive, after fumble recovery, the Aggies are then able to connect on an 8-yard TD catch to Dominique Williams as he releases the flat and takes it to the house. And this is Nunley, the kickoff return.
Got Quay Nunley brought down at the 50-yard line. Mark this at the 49.
We heard coming in. As a matter of fact, Nunley was telling me yesterday, he got to touch the ball. He wants the ball in a variety of ways. He said he's going to take kickoff back as he does right here and watch him picking his team. Great vision, explodes where there's an opening, and he needed maybe one more block to take it to the house. Well, I tell you, the pace of this game is a track meet already.
First and 10 from the 49-yard line. Give much break. 5 yards.
I was talking to Eddie George of the Tennessee Titans during the offseason. He talks about how big games are so much fast, how it took the Titans about a full half to catch up to the Super Bowl last year. This game is moving at that pace.
Again, it's Mark Banks, and he gets through for first down.
Florida A&M, at least initially, trying to take a page out of the Aggie playbook and just play power football. They got the horses up front. A lot of people want to talk about the fact that Florida A&M likes to throw the football. But Mark Banks comes in after back-to-back 100-yard performances. He was most effective last week, including a 78-yard TD run.
Once again, the swarming defense is all there. B.J. Little, we talked about it at the beginning of the game, 38, does not waste the time to sniff out the football.
Almost unblockable he is in this league. I mean, the senior from Union, South Carolina, plays off people. He always is moving, just a juggernaut, an energetic juggernaut, B.J. Little, as Quinn Gray checks off at the line of scrimmage. Now they go into a shotgun.
T.J. Hines still on his feet. Hines for another first down. Hines finally brought down at around the 27-yard line.
Well, somebody other than Nunley has to step up today. And this is a guy that's just, he's a candidate to do just that. Takes a short pass and breaks a tackle. This is a guy who's averaging over 14 yards a catch, scoring 3 touchdowns already. And you got to love these Florida A&M receivers, Ronnie, because they're so good after they catch the football.
Single backfield, play action, great. Looking for Hines, incomplete.
And he had him. Oh, did they do a great job of selling that play? Ronnie Duncan. Boy, the play action misdirection had everybody at A&T to the near side. There was nobody but Hines out there in one-on-one coverage, and the pass goes awry. Mr. Gray, we'll be thinking about that one for the next couple of plays.
And to make it second and 10, ball on the 20-yard line. Isaac Brown on the reception, and it's good for 4 yards.
Quick saved off the line. Hopefully your receiver can break tackle and take it downfield. And there's Jimmy Joe, the very talented offensive coordinator and assistant head coach from Morgan State University, class of 1977. And guess how well the going was good.
3rd and 5. Charles Allen on the reception.
Well, we've got some flag, and I think it'll be a block below the waist, or a clip of some kind. Not quite sure what happened in the center of the field. Yep. Well, let's check that call out, because he made like it was in. The infraction was against the Aggies. The indication like that normally goes against the offense. Proverbial chop block or something along the lines. Let's see if we can see what happens right here. But anyway, Allen is out here in the flat, and you talk about coming up to introduce himself rather rudely from A&T, Ahmad Blakeney. So sophomore from Charlotte. Boy, he put the rock on that time.
A 3rd and 20, ball on the 35-yard line. Out of the shotgun formation, it's Gray. Gray finds Hines, and Hines is met and hit. He didn't have any time to recover from that one. That was Sammy Rogers on the tackle.
Boy, I tell you, A&T is aggressive out here, both at the linebackers and the cornerback spot. This is designed to give his receiver another opportunity, one-on-one coverage. And then out there in coverage, just a great job that time. Just playing off the block, getting out there, a good, solid, deep drop. And this is another talented senior linebacker that knows that his defensive scheme can be successful against Florida A&M. So the Aggies dodged it. Florida A&M was rolling until that penalty, and that'll bring on the field goal opportunity.
It's Vasquez. The kick's up and it's blocked. And you know what? That is another block kick by the Aggies defense. They have done so many times this season, it is not funny. The importance of this game could be talked about so much. It's the MEAC Championship. It could be online. We'll come back with more.
Hey there, time for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Cardinal. Spend some time with national heroes. Or visit a national treasure. Or join the National Football League. But wherever you go, the National Car Rental will be there fast. With special low rates on minivans for only $229.99 per week nationwide. Or only $289.99 per week in New York. National Car Rental, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
People, today's agenda, the information.
What happened to the industrial age?
No more living in the past. Today, it's what you know that matters. He's got half a good idea over there. She's got the other half.
We get the picture.
What are we supposed to do about it?
Make it simpler for people to change ideas.
You need a digital office.
It's new software.
Relax, I've got us a partner down there.
The bell they make.
Anymore, they don't. Keep the conversation going. Share the knowledge. The digital document company. Xerox.
You've always trusted us with your letters, your bills, your packages. Now, we're bringing the security and confidence of the real world into the virtual. Introducing the U.S. Postal Service's e-bill pay. Enroll now to receive, pay, and send your bills online with the service you already know and trust.
Ken Riley is the esteemed athletic director for the FAMU Rattlers. Did you know he played for the Cincinnati Bengals? An NFL career, 15 seasons, 65 interceptions. That's the fourth highest in total, and he was a quarterback at FAMU. Now, these young ladies are going to grow up to be Rattler cheerleaders, and they're getting an early start. It's 7-0. North Carolina A&T has the lead over their beloved Rattlers. Gray,
start them young.
This game is exactly what you said it would be. And I feel like I'm about to blow. I'm just trying to sit on a fuse, and I don't want to get too ignited too early.
As great as this game has been, you just get the feeling this is the calm before the storm. We ain't seen nothing yet.
Did you see the defense coming? And they were putting pressure on Battle. He had to get rid of it quickly.
Battle did. I think it was a design type screen type of play that time where the offense lineman sort of let the linebackers and the linemen get penetration. And then you have a receiver come back across the inside, but it didn't work. It's homecoming Baltimore, and although the Bears don't have a home stadium, they will be entertaining Savannah State at PSINet Stadium. In Baltimore, Howard is at Towson State, Norfolk and Hampton, which I think is an interesting game, Ronnie, as well as South Carolina State, Bethune-Cookman, and Daytona.
There was our target scoreboard. We'll update you throughout the day with that target information as we get some scores, especially from that Savannah State working game, which kicks off in just a few moments.
Head to Bala Orange Blue, and if I could be in the line for a second, we got to protect the colors. Next TV game's coming up, Ronnie. Next week, Florida A&M, these Rattlers go to Norfolk to take on a Spartan team that we saw last week with a tremendous defense and some offensive skill players that look like they're getting it together. And it's homecoming a week after that in Greensboro. The Aggies hosting Bethune-Cookman.
Adrian Parks is back in the game. Battle, and he's being chased by Daly. Battle gets the first down. And you talk about a quarterback. What? Battle?
It was huge.
Battle with war to pick up the first down that time, Ronnie. And he almost fumbled football. Ebby Parsons in the pursuit that time. But look, once again, good pressure by the Daly coming from the backside. Battles to find his way up into the secondary. But Parsons got to remember, it's not a fumble after the knee hits ground.
All he saw was the quarterback, and it was the most important thing to see.
This Florida A&M defense is really stepping up. You look at a drastic improvement in all areas, most notably in scoring, giving up less than 10 points over the same time as last year. And Johnny on the spot, another aggressive blitz.
Hola was in there so quick. He knew that play. He had designed it himself, and knew exactly how to get to battle.
Boy, that's the second time this afternoon. He's basically come up the middle on a blitz, and before, it's a three-step drop, and bang. Boy, everybody's pumped today.
I tell you, Battle didn't even have any time to prepare on that one. 7-0, North Carolina A&T has the lead. We're still in the first quarter, and that's the scene of Pensacola, Florida. Roy Jones, hometown.
Emmitt Smith, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, most definitely. Pensacola!
In the house. Mr. Burrow stepping up and filling the hole.
Bynum was right there.
Wow.
What a huge player.
Boy,
what a huge player. Nikita, you ain't joking on this play.
Boy, he just shot that gap. It was like just coming up through the middle. They're doing a good job right now of their schemes of filling people into the middle with the linebacker coming up through different gaps. And all of a sudden, Mr. Burrow, ta-da, right there.
Once again, it was 52, Nikita Bynum. That's who got the tackle there. Give credit where credit is due. Back to pass is Battle, rolling out. Battle looking for a receiver. Incomplete. And for Helton.
That misdirection, it helped open, and
Battle just got to the outside and couldn't square up his shoulders. But made the right read. Battle was open. It's something that they can hold on to and think about for later on in the contest. So slowly but surely, the Aggies are trying to open up their offense. They said that they were going to come in here with a few tricks, and from all reports to this point in the season, they have not been aggressive with the vertical passing game, and we still have not seen Ramondo North number one other than as a punt returner. And this is a guy that's averaging something like 26 yards per reception, and we haven't seen him yet. I get the feeling sooner or later they're going to take a shot down the field.
All right, now it's time to see Matthews doing the punting. This time it's going to Isaac Brown. And it's down around the 40. You know what? This game is dramatic proportions. And Coach Joe talked about A&T earlier this year.
Of course, without question, this will be the most important game on our schedule thus far. North Carolina A&T, they're MEAC champions. And if you're going to win the MEAC this year, you have to go through Greensboro. You have to go through North Carolina A&T. And Coach Bill Hayes and his staff, they have their football team playing extremely well. He has some outstanding football players, very talented, great speed, and unbelievable size. So it's going to be a challenge to beat them, but we're just hopeful that we're up to that challenge.
All right. Coach Joe doesn't go to the sideline, but up in the coaching box is his brother, Joe.
I guess.
Coaching. And the thing about it is Jacque Nunley on the reception. Coach Joe has 210 wins. He wins today, it'll be 211. He is among just three coaches with over 200 wins in college football Division I play.
That screen is set up.
And that's Marchbank. Marchbank across the 3-yard line. Ball brought down at around the 39.
Well designed, great execution. And the thing I like about Kick Quinn Gray in that situation, he sells A&T's linebacker. Okay, you want me? You want me? You want me? Come and get me. Oops, I'm getting rid of the rock. Let Marchbank get off into the secondary, take it up and barrel over a couple of people and pick up a first down in A&T territory.
Marchbank has been a huge surprise, and watch him here go for a first down. And the reason I say that, he's a junior college transfer. He's coming in for Kelsey Lourdes, who, by the way, had a tremendous game in our first game of the season against Delaware State. However, toward the end of the game, he hurt his shoulder. This young man has come in and really provided a spark to this offense. Number 30, O.J. Marchman. They've got a T.J., they've got an O.J., they've got all kind of J's around here.
Yeah, got B.J. on the other side trying to chase O.J. down.
And I believe that was Relaford. Relaford jumping off sides, number 93. Flag was thrown in his general direction. Let's see what our officials decide. Translating the 40. That was number 93 jumping outside. You know, last week, that big fella right there, and they got uniforms to fit guys like him.
Yeah, they had to
ended up with three sacks. Not bad at all. Penalties for this game. A&T has one. FAMU has three, 25 yards. Once again, it was Isaac Brown, the intended receiver, but Gray was not able to find him when he wanted.
It's one of those things. It's like in tennis when you're at a major and you start talking about unforced errors, penalties, good reads and bad passes. They're killing the
Marchbanks. Marchbanks inside the 10-yard line, finally brought down at the 6. This young man is having a coming out party, and I believe those Rattlers are starting to sniff that end zone. Look at the holes that he's running, Mark, and it's incredible. Marchbanks continues to find a way to get the first down. Once again, it's the defense.
Boy, I tell you,
North Carolina A&T.
On those two successive run plays, A&T was blasted at the point of attack, right up the gut. And I'm sure they're a little bit shocked about that. But what happens is they come back to the outside with a short passing play, and here's Florida A&M struggling inside the red zone. Well, doing extremely well by the inside the red zone, although struggling today.
Marchbank on the give. He's down at the 3. We're going to come back with much more second quarter action coming up. It's FAMU and North Carolina A&T right here on MEAC College Football Saturday.
Whether you're at home conquering the world, venturing out into it, or just taking a break, there's a whole new way to stay connected to it. Because Verizon is giving its local customers who sign up for select digital wireless plans free internet access at home and on their wireless phones until Memorial Day 2001. It's the internet how, where, and when you want it. Call Verizon now to find out how you get it all. Then consider it done.
Family fun along with GMC and Pontiac excitement.
Get it at Capital.
Our exciting new Aztec.
That's different as different can be.
A go-anywhere Jimmy.
Or a roomy Montana van.
A professional-grade truck that pulls and pulls.
At Capital, we have all kinds of vehicles.
That provide the gang with lots of fun.
We have a great selection.
At prices and payments that are really friendly.
Come see us.
Laburnum near the airport.
Or Southside, Route 6, Powhatan.
Capital Pontiac GMC.
And an honest deal with never any hidden charges because
we care.
Get your Virginia Commonwealth soccer tickets now. This year is shaping up to be one of the best years ever for Coach O'Sullivan's squad. The Lions have dominated CAA play the last 3 years, posting an incredible 17-4-3 conference record over the time period under O'Sullivan. The Rams as they battle Maryland Saturday, October 14th, and CAA host Richmond Wednesday, October 18th, and Old Dominion Saturday, October 21st.
As you see, we've got a packed house. North Carolina A&T 7 and the Rattlers. FAMU nothing, but the Rattlers are threatening the score. And you talk about hits in this game. I feel like Casey Coleman. I feel like Casey Case. Man. I feel like Casey Duncan. I'm just feeling like Casey all over because when you get hits like that, he may want to put you in a case.
Well, it's one of those situations where there's a whole bunch of head knocking and slobber knocking going on, and you're absolutely right. We've seen a game's worth of hits in the first quarter, and now FAMU trying to get the big hit to score.
That was a 3rd and 2, and the quarterback held on to it. Al Xerox, first stats are in, and it was a game that saw North Carolina A&T do it on the ground with 78 rushing yards. FAMU, you know they would do it in the air with 55, but the 36 rushing yards, not bad. Time possession, FAMU had it the most, but North Carolina A&T has the lead. Right now, 4th down, and look at that, 52%. March Banks, is it? A touchdown, FAMU!
And the heavyweight championship bout of the MEAC continues. I've taken your haymaker, here's one from me, and they're loving it here in Tallahassee. That was just blood and guts. Get behind two canasties and let a big fullback follow home, and we're just about tied here at Breck Stadium. Well, you knew Florida A&M was going to come right back.
Vasquez tempting the point after. To the uprights and good. It's 7-7. FAMU has tied North Carolina A&T. Do we have a battle? Stick around. It gets better.
Travel provided by U.S. Airways. U.S. Airways and U.S. Airways Express offer over 4,600 flights a day in more than 250 cities throughout the U.S., Canada, the Caribbean, and Europe. Fly U.S. Airways.
All right, class. Today's lesson, saving money with Greyhound. Assume we get ourselves a Greyhound-friendly fare starting at just $49, and we use it to travel to thousands of places in the U.S. when we plan in advance. What do we save ourselves? Someone? Anyone?
A headache.
That's wrong. I can see we need more homework.
Let me help you out. Let me see.
I'm gonna turn it on in a second.
You alright?
Yeah.
Hold up. This is how we're gonna do it.
Hey,
come on.
You're in my house now. Okay? How much they paying you? Because I don't see it.
This might help you. This really might help you.
I'll take them off if I can find places.
Oops. You missed it.
Double provided by US Airways, offering the Dividend Miles program with preferred levels of membership and benefits. With US Airways, you can redeem your miles to over 500 destinations worldwide.
The FAMU Rattlers won their first of many national black championships back in 1938. That's 62 years ago. During that year, they beat A&T 13-0 back in 38, and they were undefeated 7-7. And you know that the Greyhound Band will be coming up a little bit later. Guess what? A Greyhound bus brung in the Greyhound Band.
Of course.
Well, not exactly the Greyhound Band, but one of the bands in our show. And we're going to see both the Aggies Band and the Rattlers Band all coming up. Now, kicking and doing the piece, kickoff is Lennon Nesbitt. Armando North set to receive. He picks that up at 4. Armando North still on his feet. North finally
was hit. And if he wasn't hit by Troy Hart, who knows what could have been in the end zone.
Yeah, he had seen back to the near side, and Hart stepped up and knocked his block off. But it's like he's the one that's a little bit worse for wear. And that means that Neil Coseley will have to come in, I believe, to replace him in the lineup.
As he lost his job to Hart, Hart has four interceptions leading the Rattlers defensively this season. It's a first down. The ball is at the 33-yard line for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. Your quarterback missed the bat.
Back to the ground, go to Aggies with Hitchens going up the middle and picking up tough yardage. It'll be interesting to see whether or not A&T takes advantage by trying to attack Saquon Doe, who's in there replacing Hart right now. He was the guy that we saw him starting a little bit earlier in the season when we had the Rattlers against Delaware State. And we do know that A&T will start involving a little bit more passing into their repertoire sometime shortly.
Jason Battle, your quarterback. One backfield. Battle back to pass. Battle out. Battle looking for the first down. He runs out of bounds. 40-yard line.
Battle just basically put his head down, sort of ducked in that situation. Bring up a third situation. See, like I said before, Ronnie, quarterbacks don't, it's not like you're in a high-risk offense like Florida A&M. Your quarterback has to be a field general in Greensboro. And that was a good job of field generalship by Battle.
For the latest information of MEAC schools and universities, all you have to do is go to MEACsports.com and get the latest updates. You will find some interesting factors as well as how to get tickets for the MEAC basketball tournament coming up in March Madness. Hits, but once again, it's FAMU's defense pursuing.
Boy, Daly, once again, looks like he was chasing the quarterback from the backside, and it forced a pitch a little early, and that basically disrupted the opportunity. So Florida A&M's defense sort of imposing their will right now on this game. After a couple of big running plays, they back basically clamped down on the A&T Aggies.
So much is riding on this game. We talked about it at the start. The MEAC Championship. The National Black Championship. The ground. Brought down at the 25-yard line. So much is going on. We'll win this game. We'll find out later. 7-7, A&T and FAMU.
It takes more than a good set of blueprints to construct a building. It takes a good team of skilled labor and management. Cause unites these groups in a unique partnership to maintain strong and effective relations between labor and management. The result of this effort is a better job, on time, within budget, and with a commitment to excellence. This teamwork benefits everyone, owners, builders, developers, and the consumer. Cause, the contractors and union seal of excellence. Cause, we keep Washington working.
Whether you're at home, conquering the world, venturing out into it, or just taking a break from it, there's a whole new way to stay connected to it. Now, when Verizon local customers sign up for select digital wireless plans, they can get 150 hours of free internet access at home every month, plus free mobile web access through Memorial Day 2001. Just call 1-800-775-0045 today and get it all free. Now, thanks to a new kind of company called Verizon, you can harness the internet from wherever and whenever you choose. Verizon local customers call 1-800-775-0045 today and get 150 hours of free internet access at home, plus free mobile web access through Memorial Day 2001. Want the internet free and on your terms? Consider it done.
A lot of stuff to talk over. It's 7-7, North Carolina A&T and FAMU.
If I'm North Carolina A&T, certainly on the offensive front right now, I'm thinking about trying to attack Florida A&T deep downfield. If I'm Florida A&M, hey, you know the blitz is coming. What can I do to keep off balance? And O.J. Marksman's doing a great job of that. They're going right at the center of the A&T defense. And, you know, you would think that's a strong point, but Florida A&M went right for the heart of the A&T defense with the run game. And they've been effective to this point all afternoon.
Marksman's, the junior college transfer, continues to be huge and pick up big yards.
A little bit of movement early. I'm just wondering, did A&T move into the neutral zone or were they drawn offside? Seems like there might have been just a little twitch on the Rattler offensive front. Let's see what happens.
James Coleman.
Well, as you can see, Marchbanks has been having a huge day. Let's take a look at some of the things he's been doing so far today. And the junior college transfer has impressed me.
It's one particular hole that he's running through, and that's that A-gap, man. And he's just blasting at the point of attack. Our big nasty's up front, and he's following through gaping holes. Holes that I run through.
James Agnew, number 67, is one of the reasons why big fella's uniform may not fit properly, but he plays.
Boy, I tell you, Gay just shoved somebody on the A&T defense front. Might have been Victor Clay. And it's getting testy, boy. There's no love lost here.
Ray Mack, number 55, letting everybody know that this is the Blue Depth defense. We don't play around. What a game is coming to you live from Tallahassee, Florida. Mark Gray, Ronnie Duncan, giving you the action. Bragg Stadium on the campus of FAMU. Gray back pass. Gray lets it go to Jacque Nunley. First down. And Nunley catches it at the 45-yard line.
That's why I don't understand the beef that people have with Quinn Gray down here. This is a disciplined move by him. Phil Generalson, wait, he's baiting the linebacker. Hit me. And then what that does is it gives his All-American receiver an opportunity to complete his route, and Nunley hauled in.
And once again, another reception for Jacque Nunley as he gets closer and closer to that elusive record of 301 catches by Jerry Rice. Nunley once again, and that's getting close to that first down mark.
Yeah, the senior from Miami that time is kicking himself because he was trying to put one move on, and he almost shook himself out of his shoes, and that's why he wasn't able to pick up the first down. But finding ways right now on crossing routes to get Nunley open, and it is a very, very difficult challenge for Montrell Pittman right now.
Ball of fumble, and I believe it's going to go to the Aggies.
Yes, it does. And Florida.
Leonard Relaford, once again, being alert on the football. He might be a big fella at 6'3", 250 pounds, and they say he's about 270, but wow, he responds to the football.
That's a good job right there. Just Johnny on the spot, filling the hole, making the stop, and recovering. Relaford is having a huge game up front.
And that was the problem with FAMU last week, I guess. Grambling,
yep.
Turning the ball over at the Circle City Classic. It was so unlike them, so uncharacteristic. Right down is Hicks, and Hicks is met hard and hit hard. FAMU on the defense, getting it done. Carlos Moore.
Boy, stepping up, the freshman from right here in Tallahassee gets right into the thick of this ball game by drilling Hicks. I mean, he had to check to make sure he was still connected to his shoes after that shot. Look at it right here. See, he plays off the block and just stays with the play to deliver a shot. Boy, just outstanding work time by the freshman in the secondary. Clearly the biggest game of his career.
And we saw that play was Vickers. Now Vickers, number three. And of course, coming in to finish the job off was Moore. That was good isolation by our photographers, who were able to get that great camera shot. That's how Vickers was so disciplined on the play.
And that time, what we saw coming up in support, watch this right here. Look, he wanted to dance to the outside, but Coda, that time just coming up in the middle, filling, and he's not being denied. You know, you talk a lot about the aggressiveness and the athleticism and the speed that the A&T linebackers play with. Florida A&M's linebackers don't have to take a back seat to anybody.
Dominique Williams finally got down. He wasn't fooled that time, and Cola was not about to be the joke of the day.
We knew A&T was going to open up the offense, and they tried to go the bag of tricks, and that was a play that was doomed from the start. Battle trips over himself, has difficulty getting the ball to Williams, and by that time, Cola has read the play, and then makes the play. Read the play, see the play, read the play, make the play. Good job by Cola that
Yannick
time.
Matthews on the punt. Receiving this, Isaac Brown finally brought out of bounds. And we're going to come back with much more this game. It's 7-7, the Aggies and the Rattlers.
He's got Agatron. I'll exchange it.
Introducing e-merchandise return from the United States Postal Service. It's so simple, your customers can print a prepaid return label right from your website. Now the stuff they buy online practically returns itself. Easier exchange with them means more business for you. What's your e-priority?
I like an eagle. News in 30 brings you news, views, interviews, what have you. Monday Street Talk, opinions from the heart of the city. Tuesday Street Talk, political talk with a new perspective. Wednesdays As It Is, tell the news as it is, and let the chips fall where they may. Thursday, local and world news from the Reuters team. And Friday, word on the street forecasts on possible news headlines for the following week. News in 30, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7:30 a.m.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
It's 8:25 remaining before halftime. 7-7 North Carolina A&T and Florida A&M. What a game we've got. Four wide receivers in the game. For the Rattlers, it is Quinn Gray, the quarterback, the running back in the backfield, March Bynes, but he is brought down. Wow, that was McLean, Bryce McLean, number 7 on the tackle.
Good job that time, A&T, with so many aggressive defensive players. And let's take a look at the turnovers, which have been a big story to this point. They really affected, you know, Florida A&M's play in this game. They were moving twice in the red zone. A&T was able to make big plays. You had a little ball here. This is Dunley making a catch and getting out of bounds. And it is close to a first down for Florida A&M. In fact, the chains will move, Ronnie.
Absolutely. Dunley with his fourth catch of the day. This young man keeps getting closer and closer to that record. And you know what? I hope he gets it. I hope he gets it next week so everyone can see it on television when we go to Norfolk State. And it's Norfolk State and FAMU.
FAMU picking up the pace of the offense just a little bit. If you notice, they're quicker, a lot quicker than they were in the first quarter.
First and March Banks for a gain of 2 yards. Now for more on sidelines. Let's go to Jeff Runner.
Guys down here on the sideline in the A&T offensive huddle, coaches were stressing to the offensive line the importance of blocking. We saw on that last possession, the A&T defenders got in there and wreaked havoc. Back up to you.
All right, Jeff, I'm wondering basically whether it's really hot down there, if that's going to have any effect on the game. Gray going to Hines and incomplete.
Boy, I tell you. This is a situation where Quinn Gray has to be upset with himself. It's about the third time that he's had somebody wide open or relatively open that he's not gotten the ball to give them an opportunity to make a play. An unforced error on the quarterback in a big game is a recipe for disaster.
11 carries for March Banks, 61 yards, and you know this young man is having a huge day. Quinn Gray wants to make sure he has a huge one as well. Back to passes Gray. Gray was going for Charles Allen and another interception. He threw the first interception last week in the Circle City Classic, and this time is Blackney with the interception for the Aggies.
That's right, Blackney with picking off the fourth INT over the last 2 weeks by Gray, who went 200 passes to start the season without throwing one. Throws off his back foot, a bad pass, and you know, a junior quarterback in a critical game, the leader of the offense, has got to play stay within himself. That's a quarterback that's forcing, maybe pressing just a little bit, and he's got to go back, adjust, talk to his coaches upstairs, and not make those mistakes again.
7:01 remaining for halftime, and you know he's going to be talking to head coach Billy Joe about that miscue. There is Hicks on the carry, close to a first down, but they will gain about maybe 8 on the play.
Do you like offensive line play? Because I'm going to tell you, the two centers on these two teams are just blasting folks at the point of attack. I got to tell you something. Both Terry Logan for Florida A&M and the center Victor Mark are having tremendous games. I don't know what formula that the MEAC folks use for grading out O-linemen, but those two guys are having a marvelous game, and that's why Hicks is going off right now. Well,
you know, last week Hicks had 183 yards on 17 carries and 2 touchdowns. This week, maybe by halftime, he will already have 100 yards. He's got 90 right now.
Well, let's give credit where credit is due. Last week, TD runs of 738 yards. He's already got a 60-plus yard run on the afternoon, so be interesting to see if FAMU is vulnerable against something like that.
North on the end and around, looking for the first down. North Carolina A&T. Michael North, fine receiver, kick return specialist for the Aggies.
Got to get him more touches if you ask me.
Most definitely. You got to get Chris Paul in the game. Number 27. Normally wears number 4, but he's a small receiver. Someone like the Smurfs of the Washington Redskins back in the day of those Super Bowl days. There he is, number 1, Ramondo North. Once again, this is MEAC Football Saturday. Two teams undefeated in the conference. 4-0 for the Rattlers, 2-0 for North Carolina A&T. That's why this game is so huge and so big. Jason Battle is your quarterback. In the backfield. Hicks. Hicks on the carry. Hicks across the 20, the 15, 10. MEAC, see you later.
Oh, man. What a run. Oh, my goodness. And terrific downfield blocking by the wide receivers to spring him. It was a block by the receivers downfield. It was a difference because it looked like Vickers had a shot to bring down, and Hicks just blasted it right up top once again.
Two big runs, a 35-yard touchdown run for Marvin Hicks, number... Oh, my goodness. The kid, 35 yards, number 22. And you know what? He has over 100 yards, 125 right now on the day. Let's see what happens with the play after. Will it be 14-0 A&T? The kick is up, and the kick is good. Once again, a 35-yard touchdown by Maurice Hicks, and the Aggies once again take lead. We'll come back with much more of MEAC College Football Saturday.
That is so sweet.
Here's a free phone for making the donation.
Want a free digital phone from Cellular One? Donate $20 to Special Olympics. Cellular One.
Don't miss your chance to see NBA basketball up close and personal in the NBA Classic 2000. The NBA comes to the Richmond Coliseum Saturday, October 21st at 7 p.m. Watch the Washington Wizards battle the Boston Celtics in preseason NBA action. Tickets are on sale now at the Coliseum box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. Charge by phone 804-262-8100 or online at www.ticketmaster.com.
This is Robin. And this is Rockin' Robin's. Rocking chairs, recliners, tables, and drawers like most people have never seen before. Which was kind of the problem until Robin showed them on cable TV. And now sales are, well, you know, cable advertising. It's easy, it's affordable, it works. AT&T Media Services. Get your ads worth.
It's a matter of anything you can do, I can do better. The Aggies are leading right now, 14-7. The reason why, you see the man right there, number 22, Maurice Hicks. He has 125 yards on the day, a 35-yard run, and he wants to make sure everybody in Greensboro, North Carolina, knows what he can do. Here's how Greyhound scoring. It took three plays, 32 seconds, a 35-yard run by Maurice Hicks.
And you got to give props to the downfield blocking of the wide receivers that did an excellent job of springing him into the end zone, and now Quinn Gregg has to gather this offense, a talented offense, and put him on his back right now. And the A&T aggressive defense basically isn't having it.
Virgil Neal on the tackle.
So linebackers come in droves in Aggie line or something, boy. Look at this guy once again playing off a block, little blitz package, gets unabated to the running back this time, and hauls him back.
One of the very few times March Banks has been brought down. Gray back to pass. He finds March Banks. Marks Banks gets around 5 yards on the play, brought down at around the 25-yard line.
That's a great job playing off his block that time and making the tackle was by Ray Massey.
Ray Massey, one of the talented linebackers for the Aggies.
Staying at home, playing off his block, and then bringing the back down.
Third and five. T.J. Hines, first down.
Hines is definitely the dangerous one in terms of, you know, after the catch. Now watch him right here. This is a safe route. When you spread the field and he's a slot guy, it's too much cushion by the linebackers and the safety that time, and they'll just continue to work that underneath stuff all the way down the field.
Messi on the tackle. Oh, Banks.
And again, Gray must be at the helm because the pace is definitely quickened.
Action.
when Gray going to Isaac Brown. Pass incomplete, too long.
Wow. A little bit more touch, and Brown is able to run under it and hold it home. He had gotten a step on the coverage, and he could have taken it to the house. But that's one of those situations, once again, we're talking about unforced errors all day with Gray. That's another.
That'll make it third and eight. Long third down situation for the Rattlers of FAMU. What a huge crowd we've got. Over 20,000 here at Bragg Memorial Stadium. Gray calling his own shots. High formation. Third down conversions in and out of the hands of Jack Wade Nunley there for North Carolina A&T. It's Montrell Pittman.
Pittman does a good job in coverage, and that was just a high pass. Now, granted, when you're on the verge of becoming the all-time leading receiver in college history, that's one of those catches you definitely have to try to make. But it was not your, you know, atypical textbook type of catch. It wasn't like that pass was right between the numbers. And now Florida A&M's offense has definitely got to try to impose their will on this game in their next drive, because this is a danger zone. If they don't make the adjustment defensively and A&T is able to continue to run the ball, we could have a blowout on our hands all of a sudden.
T.J. Smith, the punt, and it's blocked. Picked up by the Aggies. Evans on the block.
Boy, I think this Asa Evans is one of the better special teams performers in the NAC, and the aggressiveness of the Aggie defense once again showing itself. Boy, I tell you, they've been coming oh so close as both teams at time. Couldn't see who got the block, but A&T right now with a golden opportunity after it's hauled in and taken down to about the 29-yard line of Florida A&M. You talk about having an opportunity to seize command. This is what the Aggies are doing right now.
All right, Booker Washington on the recovery. Evans on the block. Once again, it's battle to give the Hicks. Hicks turning the corner one more time. Hicks at the 20. Hicks inside the 10. MEAC, see you later.
And once again, the downfield blocking of the wide receivers gives him a lane, and he's able to follow him. This is just outstanding run blocking by North Carolina A&T, and I'm just overwhelmed that they are having with their way right now on the ground. Look, ship this time downfield, number 5, you'll see come in, number 13 with a great block as well for A&T in that situation. Darius helped, and then Hicks is able to take it in the house. And suffice to say, the Rattlers are in a bit of trouble right now.
Who would have thunk it? The point after, just about to go up. And it's good, 21-7, North Carolina A&T, and that young man, you talk about a hero. He's no zero today. Wow.
Boy, this kid has like, what, 16 now over the last 2 weeks unofficially? It's at least 5, and I am very, very impressed.
They said he had his coming out party last week against Morgan, and then you see what happens this week, 180 yards and right down. He surpassed even that. Bethune-Cookman in the Sheridan Network poll, North Carolina A&T. FAMU is 4th, and look at Hampton, number 6. That is something pretty huge when you've got 4 MEAC teams in the top 6.
And I'm not going to endear myself to anybody in Daytona Beach, but I don't agree with Bethune-Cookman, number 1. You look at their schedule, they've got like 3 wins over Division II opposition. I would slide A&T and Florida A&M up to 1-2. When you look at their losses, those losses have been against solid 1AA opposition. But you're right, 4 teams in the top 6, and I don't really think anybody in the MEAC has really hit their stride 100% yet.
I tell you what, it's going to be interesting when you consider that right now, as we speak, you have 4 teams that are undefeated in the conference. Look at those numbers for Maurice Hicks. 9 carries, 152 yards. Is this not a career game? I guarantee you, his mom, his pop, his grandma, his aunt, his uncle, his cousins, and all of his friends are running tape of this game. He'll make sure he'll get this one for a lifetime.
He came into the game averaging only 5.5 yards per carry and 61 yards a game, and he's doubled both of them to this point already.
Pretty amazing. Jacque Nunley, talk about the numbers for him. Well, you know, each and every time he gets a catch, it's closer and closer to a record. You know, if you look at this young man, you talk to some of the students on campus, they say, Ronnie, he doesn't look like a football player. You would never know that Jacque Nunley is the type of guy that he is, but he's a big man on campus doing great things.
And I thought coming in, he was going to have to find a way to make to catch 10 passes in this contest. And, you know, trailing by 2 touchdowns, 4 minutes to go, I think he's going to get some opportunities now.
When Gray
He's under attack, and the reason why, it was O'Neal.
Boy, A&T's aggressiveness, they're just pinning their ears back right now and just coming after Quinn Gray because they know that, first off, the Rattlers trail, and Quinn's just a little off. He's sort of out of sync right now. He's made bad passes to open receivers, and now he's getting peppered by some mistakes by his offensive line, which is to take nothing away from the schemes that A&T is running right now on their defensive front.
Second and 15, the pass to Hine. Hine is able to get some of it back, but not enough for a first down, T.J. Hines.
But at least the chains do move just a little, give him a little bit more room to work with. And A&T has done a good job of taking away the deep stuff.
See, I'm very impressed with Quinn Gray's arm. It's when Quinn Gray goes back to pass where I have a problem. He does not have the fastest feet or does not show a tremendous amount of poise. Sure, he's big and sure, he's strong, but his feet are not very fleet.
And he struggled with
that right there. Jacque Nunley, Nunley for a first down. And once again, that's why this young man is so dangerous. It's what he does after he gets the football. Jacque Nunley, if my numbers are right, that's his sixth catch of the day.
Well, one thing about it is, you know, the big players are going to have to step up to bring you back. And this is what you take, a little dump pass, which is a little nothing, and you turn it into a first down.
Gray drops back to pass, once again on his feet. That time intended for Charles Allen, pass incomplete.
But he does a good job at that time of escaping the sack. And that was a smart decision. He did a good job of getting. Now see, watch. Here once again, pressure coming from Massey. And then Doe gets him around the leg so he couldn't step and follow through, and that's why that pass goes awry. But the
Sammy
receiver
Rogers
was
out there, number 41. He was on the attack. In and out of the hands of DeMar Bowe, number 4.
And this is a kid that had a big first game of the season. We had seen him, we expected big things, but certainly the main weapon in the arsenal is clearly Nunley. I wonder if Bo's not still making dinner for the team. She told us in Dover that she normally has him over every Thursday and Gray's in a little bit of trouble, but he finds Bo again. Good job of concentration by not only Gray, but Bo hauling the pass in and then picking up a couple of more yards, but it looks like the Rattlers are going to have to punt once again.
That's right, not enough for first down, putting them in another punting situation. Doing the punting for the Rattlers, T.J. Smith out of Columbia, Maryland. Junior, who, by the way, has been averaging nearly 41 yards a punt this season. And that will take a nice bounce at around the 19-yard line.
So if you're North Carolina A&T here, what do? Do you crank it up? Do you look to attack downfield? We haven't seen Ramondo in the passing game.
Is that a trick question?
Well, it is, I don't know, because think about it. You've been so effective running football.
The reason I say that is because, you know, Bill Hayes wants to pile it on. You know he doesn't want to play around. He's got these folks right now really quiet. Have you noticed that you've got over 20,000 people here? Most of them are what, Rattler fans, and most of them are quiet right now. On a 12-game MEAC winning streak, you know, one more.
And they tie Hampton, exactly.
How about that? They tied the MEAC record.
That's the point.
This time, Hicks is finally wiped down. He's human.
But that's the point I was trying to make. Do you take the reins off? Do you start trying to attack downfield with the vertical pass game? Or do you continue to run through basically the A-gap, something that until that play had been there all afternoon?
I'll tell you what, man, you just keep running the football. If it's working well for you, why stop the engine and turn it off? That was Cola on the tackle. We've got a timeout.
So for all this stuff we heard about the Aggies taking the reins off their offense, going downfield to attack vertically, a whole bunch of misdirections and half rolls and waggle plays, it's been good old-fashioned smash-mouth football, bloody the opposition's nose, and that's why the Aggies are leading this game right now.
All right, Mark Gray, you know what, the players of the week, tell Troutman. Love this kid, 161 yards rushing, 153 passing, and that's why Bethune-Cookman is undefeated. Then you see Mr. Mathis on the defense for Bethune-Cookman. He got the job done, 5 solo tackles and 4 interceptions. And look at the list, and you see that guy who's a rookie, Maurice Hicks? He was the rookie of the week last week. He might be the player of the week this week with the type of numbers he's put up thus far in the first half of this game. over 150 yards and some long touchdown runs.
Yes, indeed. And, you know, you got to give credit where credit is due to the big horses up front who are doing a tremendous job. Dwayne Hammett, Chris Kinlock, Victor Mart, Carol Burley, and Quazi Mitchell are having their way right now, certainly in the interior of the Florida A&M defensive front. You also have to give big props to the Aggie wide receivers whose downfield blocking has been darn near legendary this afternoon. I mean, I haven't seen downfield blocking like that since John Taylor and Jerry Rice were in San Francisco and trying to lead Roger Craig down in for a long touchdown.
Tell you what a game has been, and see some great players on both sides, and by no intent is this to say the Rattlers cannot come back, because if you've ever seen this offense before, then you know Coach Billy Joe has a high-octane offense. Quentin Gray, before you know it, will have points on the board. So stick around. It's going to be a great one. Battle back to pass. Battle still on his feet. Battle. Cola there. Finally brought down. And it was final. Did you see the Rattler defense? They had Battle battling for his life.
Well, I think off the half roll, like what? It's a little reverse action. Fake, and then he goes back to the far side. He wanted to go down the center of the field to try and find Ramondo North, but Cola was not having it. He got blocked, got up off his feet, and that just set it up for Bynum to get the sack.
Bynum on the sack.
And now this becomes a big play.
Now this becomes a huge play, because what you were talking about earlier, whether or not Coach Hayes wants to sit on it, going to halftime with a 21-7 lead, that's a possibility. And those are things perhaps Coach Hayes is talking about. You know, he is a graduate of North Carolina Central, out of Durham, North Carolina. This is his 13th season now with the Aggies. He's won 90 games. He's the all-time winningest coach in North Carolina A&T history, and that's huge. Coach Billy Hayes, and he loves his players to be full-time players, and they come to play each and every time. Great guy, sometimes very misunderstood, but I tell you, I get it. I get it, and I like the guy. I think that he does an excellent job. And then on the other sideline, you see right there, the defensive coordinator saying, we have got to do a better job of containment. And, of course, that's FAMU.
Well, it's third down and long, so a very interesting situation right here. Florida A&M has one timeout left. If they hold here, you figure that AT will have to kick the ball from the end zone with the high-octane offense, take a timeout, then you give your offense an opportunity to steal a touchdown. We saw him steal a touchdown in Dover to open the season, and that turned the tide of that game. Just a huge playoff side.
Well, you see the timeout situation remaining for both teams. Just spotted for you, third and 20. Can you believe Hicks? What a run. Did anyone tell this kid there are blockers on the other side, guys who are trying to tackle him? Murray Hicks, number 22, continues to get the job done.
I'm just so impressed right now with the play of Martin Kinlock. As you're sending your left guard, they're just blasting people right now. He does a good job of following his blocks. The holes are there right now. I mean,
the holes might be there, but Mark.
The holes are there.
This guy broke tackles, and all you got to do is look at the replays. That's effort, that's tenacity, and he was doing a lot of them by himself. You talked about some big hits. We've had some big hits. We've had some big sacks, and we've got them all on videotape for you. As a matter of fact, take a look at this collage of videotape highlights.
Well, once again, that's Cola hauling in Hicks, who was trying to throw a pass, which required an effort. Gray is called in that time. I believe that's Mr. Little. Coming back, getting the outside. This is Battle in trouble. He's brought down in that situation. So both front sevens, aggressive and active up front. Guys like Nakia Bynum and Gray Masson, B.J. Little, Leonard Rolfe, Jerron Daly, all have huge first halves right now. And North Carolina A&T has the punt. Now, it's a very precarious situation here, because you know the Rattlers are going to go after the punter here.
And Isaac Brown is capable of taking it into the end zone for six on their side. The punt is up. Brown is going to field this at the 35-yard line. Brown at the 40. Brown moving. Brown still on his feet. Brown at the 50. Turning the corner. Brown at the 40. Brown at the 45. 35. Brown still on his feet. Brown at the 31-yard line. Isaac Brown.
That's why holding A&T on that third down was so big. You just had the feeling that there was one big offensive play left in the front of A&M repertoire, and Brown gives his team, a struggling offensive unit, a wonderful opportunity at the end of the first half.
He is a single safety. There's nobody blocking for him. And this is just individual effort. Finding the seam, using his vision, gets a couple of blocks, and he just explodes to the corner and runs out of real estate. Just a great job by Brown. It's up to Gray in the offense, and a bad snap. Oh, a killer for Florida A&M.
They have had problems with that this entire game. Bobble snaps, fumble snaps, and that, again, a bad snap way over the head of the quarterback, Quinn Gray.
A silent snap count, and you figure that the quarterback and the center would be on the same page of the book. You've played half a season, and just a devastating turn of events for Florida A&M.
You can imagine what the sound will be like in the locker room of the Rattlers. We cannot continue to make crucial mistakes at a time like that. Wayman White, the receiver. A pickup of 3 yards on the play.
This is a Florida A&M team that played in the national quarterfinals last year. They've won big games on the road. They played NFL venues all season. Pressure should not be getting to them, but it looks like they've got a place of the bobbles.
Quinn Gray holding out. And he's down in the end zone, and there's a flag on the play, and you know that flag is against the Aggies.
For the first time, Sammy Rogers, the senior, a little bit overzealous. Gray clearly had 1 foot on the white, and it'll give him 15 yards and an automatic first down. A&T has dodged the bullet, and then Sammy Rogers, with one big hand, cost the team 15 yards and the ball. And you talk about huge plays. If the Rattlers are able to get into the end zone here, boy, the folks in Greensboro will be talking about Mr. Rogers, and campus won't be his neighborhood.
7 seconds left to go just before halftime. What a huge
first blow to fade.
Now they've brung in Juan Vasquez for the field goal.
Charles, Allen is your holder, but we've got another timeout. North Carolina A&T will try to gather themselves.
North Carolina A&T, first yards timeout.
This is when you think about your special team plays and blocking a potential field goal. And in there, that's the coach, Coach Lee Joe of the Rattlers, trying to get their stuff together to make sure that if Vasquez is going to hit this one, it will be a good one. This will be about a 45-yarder for Vasquez as well.
But Coach Hayes told Jeff in our open that he wanted his team to play disciplined football but be aggressive. The Aggie defense in the last play had been a textbook performance in the first half. That was one bit of overzealous, over-aggressive defensiveness, if you will, and that could cost North Carolina A&T 3 points, and three gift points in a game of this magnitude, because you just get the feeling that for A&M, he's not going to play as bad an offense as they played in the first half and the second half. And now Vasquez will try about a 44-yard field goal to try to get some of the momentum back to the Rattlers as we end the first half. Oh, now the ice job begins. Look at the gamesmanship. That's just the ice the kicker at the end of the first half.
You know, I was making a motion to you.
A&T, second charge timeout.
That's A&T's second charge timeout. And as you can see, Vasquez right now, the nerves. This young man has to be thinking about it right now. I mean, every time he gets ready to get set, there's a timeout. Either he's called it, meaning you, or North Carolina A&T is going to be quite interesting. Man, 4 seconds left to go on the clock. 21-7 is the score for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. Something we have not mentioned in this game. They have played 3 times in the last 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
But the Aggies have won 2 of those contests. Now you got to ask the question, with this large crowd on hand, witnessing this great affair here at Bragg's Memorial Stadium, whether or not the Aggies have the Rattlers' number. And that has to be under consideration. I mean, let's face it, last season I've been doing games in the MEAC, and everyone had basically given the national championship, and I'm talking about the MEAC championship, away to FAMU. Here it is. Let's see.
It's another timeout.
It's another timeout.
It's the game. It's the game within a game. Bill Hayes is trying to ice Vasquez, and in a game of this magnitude, every second counts. And he's playing the last 4 seconds of the first half in trying to ice Juan Vasquez, much like he would play the last 4 seconds of regulation. This is classic gamesmanship right here. Now let's take a look at 2 big plays from earlier this afternoon, Ronnie.
plays that have been a big factor in this game. And of course, as we roll the MEAC later take, Ronnie, this is Maurice Hicks, who takes it up, dances from the inside to the outside, and almost takes it to the house, which sets up A&T's first score. And then coming back, this is Isaac Brown. Nothing but individual effort, taking it down deep into A&T territory to give the Rattler offense an opportunity to score. But a bad snap has put them into a situation where they'll attempt a 44-yard kick by Juan Vasquez.
He could be another big play in the game, and another big play. The kick is up. And it's good. A 44-yard field goal. And this young man must have ice in his veins, because every time he turned around, they were trying to get him to purpose. But Mr. Vasquez says, watch my foot. You know, and watch it go through the end zone in the upright. And now the Rattlers are coming back. It's 21-10 at halftime.
It's like a basketball game where guys go to the free throw line. You've got the crowd waving at you. You've got to nail the three-point or the free throws. Well, Vasquez showed toughness, moxie, and for those of you who are impaired, chutzpah. You like that word, didn't you? You didn't think I know about that.
Hey, not bad for you, Mark. Not bad for you. The great vocabulary continues to expand each and every weekend. Let's go to Jeff Rumlin, who's on the sideline. He's going to be talking pretty soon to one of the coaches and participants. We've got some of the players still on the field, and I guess they're wondering whether or not there's time still on the clock. And if that is the case, then the officials have got to bring both teams back onto the field, and we've got to play out those last few seconds just before halftime. This is going to be interesting. Coming up at halftime, we've got both bands in our NUE and Greyhound band shows. We've also got a feature of a young man who has moved up from the MEAC to the NFL.
First foul call.
And I guess they would.
It occurred. Half the play was over. The penalty would be marked off at the beginning of the kickoff. The field goal is good.
Okay, so that end, what an end to a crazy first half. It's only fitting that something crazy would happen.
But you know what? That is what it's all about in college football, in a game such as this. This game is of this magnitude, and things have been great. Now, Jimmy Joe, who happens to be the offensive coordinator for the FAMU Rattlers, is talking to our Jeff Rumlin. Jeff, take it away.
Thanks, guys. Coach Joe, turnovers. Once again, like last week, here killing you in the first half.
Yeah, turnovers are killing us, and if it's going to really hurt us, outcome us for the outcome of the game if we don't do something about the turnovers. And we're making some adjustments, and hopefully the second half will show some improvement.
Some people thought North Carolina A&T would maybe come out and pass more. Right now they're still playing smash mouth football. What do you do in the second half to correct those mistakes?
Well, defensively, we're going to have to tighten it down up front, because evidently they found a hole in our defensive line, and they're pounding us and punishing us. So what we're going to do is tighten it up a little bit on defense and try to open up just a little bit more on offense.
All right. Thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Guys, back upstairs to you.
All right, Jeff Rumlin on the sideline. What a game it is. 21-10. North Carolina A&T with the lead. We've got a halftime show with the Battle Bands coming your way after this.
Somehow, we've been able to institutionally capture that magnificent interface between the strong liberal arts tradition and high-tech mode to produce the place where dreamers become achievers, from astronauts to brothers.
North Carolina A&T State University, where the best get better.
Hey there, time for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Carnival. Spend some time with national heroes, or visit a national treasure, or join the National Football League. Wherever you go, let National Car Rental get you there fast. With special low rates on minivans from $229.99 per week nationwide, or only $289.99 per week in New York. National Car Rental, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
Enjoy the moments that a new day brings. Everyone in the world has song to sing. Live every day, let it sing.
All right, class, today's lesson
saving money with Greyhound. Assume we get ourselves a Greyhound-friendly fare starting at just $49, and we use it to travel to thousands of places in the U.S. when we plan in advance. What do we save ourselves? Someone? Anyone?
A headache.
That's wrong. I can see we need more homework.
Yeah, if you are.
I'm going to turn it on in a second.
You all right?
Oh, yeah.
Hold up. Yeah. That's how we're going to do it. Hey, come on.
You're my house now, okay?
Two shots.
I'm going to stay paying you.
Two shots you got.
I don't see it.
This might help you. This really might help you.
Take them off if I can find them in laces.
Oops. Hope you miss it.
Welcome back. We've got a game of 21-10. North Carolina A&T leading the Rattlers of FAMU. Now let's join our NUE Bancho. It's the Aggies' blue and gold marching machine under the direction of Dr. Johnny Hodge, who's been directing this band since 1980.
Whether you're at home conquering the world, venturing out into it,
or just taking a break from it, there's a whole new way to stay connected to it. Now, when Verizon Low customers sign up for select digital wireless plans, they get 150 hours of free internet access at home every month, plus free mobile web access through Memorial Day 2001. Just call 1-800-775-0045 today and get it all free. Now, thanks to a new kind of company called Verizon, you can harness the internet from wherever and whenever you choose. Verizon local customers call 1-800-775-0045 today and get 150 hours of free internet access at home, plus free mobile web access through Memorial Day 2001. Want internet free and on your terms? Consider it done.
That is so sweet.
Hey, here's your free phone for making the donation.
One free digital phone from Cellular One. Donate $20 to Special Olympics. Cellular One.
Tom Hickey from BG Products and Tom Enterprises. We're here to show you that BG Products are for your car to make it run like new and high performance like this race car. If you want to hear more about what BG Products can do for your car, tune into Your Car and What It Takes on Friday Night Lab TV.
For the past 20 years, Hardee's has been a premier sponsor of Special Olympics Virginia. Help support these 13,000 athletes from across the Commonwealth with a $1 or $5 donation at your local participating Hardee's restaurant. And become a star supporter for Special Olympics Virginia. Not only does Hardee's support Special Olympics, but it also employs Special Olympics athletes. With Hardee's and Special Olympics, you can inspire greatness, Virginia athletes. Thank you.
Back is 21-10. North Carolina A&T with the lead. And on the field right now is the Marching 100. Band of FAMU as our band show continues right here. And you know what? We've got a halftime show to give to you because it is 21-10. And Mark Gregg, this football game has given us more excitement than we ever could imagine for one man, especially Maurice Hicks of North Carolina A&T.
You talk about stepping up and a big-time player stepping up in a big-time game. That's exactly what Maurice Hicks is doing. As they say on the yard, he is straight going off, barreling over people, going right through the A-gap. Look at him, exploding, dancing to the far sideline, opening up the can early in the first quarter. And that set up a golden scoring opportunity that A&T wasn't able to take advantage of. This time, hey, I'm going to do it for myself. Blasting through that A-gap once again. Tremendous downfield blocking, and Hicks takes it to the house. Here he comes back with a second touchdown. Once again through that A-gap. Once again, great job of blocking deep downfield by the running back. Excuse me, by the receivers. And that has opened the door for Hicks to just have a tremendous first half. And I tell you, unless Florida A&M makes an adjustment to the A-gap, North Carolina A&T and Hicks and Parks and Aylock, whoever's back there, is going to continue to go off, and that's the story in the game. Florida A&M's inability to contain North Carolina A&T through the A-gap, that's where Hicks is going off.
One guy hasn't had a big game, but he has 45 yards on five catches. Jacque Nunley, he has five catches in this game. However, maybe FAMU is not going to Mr. Nunley as often as they should.
Well, I'm the kind of guy that believes he needs at least 10 or 12 touches in the afternoon. Look at him. He goes across the middle, gray binds time. He finds his favorite target. This is Nunley getting a short pass, taking it, and turning it something a little bit larger. So when you look at Jacque Nunley, I got to think that you may see him in the offensive backfield coming out into the flats. You may see him go deep downfield. I think Florida A&M is really helping North Carolina A&T outright by not attacking vertically downfield. We saw against Delaware State. As long as they were throwing that underneath stuff, the Hornets were able to stay in the game. As soon as they went up top and started going deep, that's when the offensive momentum turned around. I think that's going to have to be this one in the second half if Florida A&M is going to get back into
it. One guy came up a huge play just before halftime. Juan Vasquez, a 44-yard field goal. And I tell you what, that was a huge one. It made it 21-10, and it gave FAMU something to go into the locker room saying, we can come back. Remember, this is our house. It's Bragg Memorial. And here's our Xerox. And Mark, the stats say it for itself. 186 yards for North Carolina A&T. And Maurice Hicks has 143 of that. We'll come back with much more of our best show as we continue 21-10 A&T with the lead.
Is a rite of passage, and if you master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield even to yourself, you'll be changed forever. You, the proud, the Marines.
John was brilliant.
I knew everything.
John with that consolidated contract didn't even tell us where he put it.
Now they're really consumed with grief.
If only they knew John scanned all of his documents to the Xerox Document Center.
You don't think John scanned the contract to the
Xerox Document Center?
The Xerox Document Center, do you?
John was smart, but he wasn't that smart.
I don't think John liked that.
Keep the conversation going. Share the knowledge. The digital document company, Xerox.
You've all trusted us with your letters, your bills, your patches. Now, we're bringing the security and confidence of the real world into the virtual one. Introducing the U.S. Postal Service's e-bill pay. Enroll now to receive, pay, and send your bills online with the service you already know and trust.
Fly like an eagle into the future.
Fall to October with New Earth Entertainment. For a special free weekend.
Really? That is so cool!
On October 6th, 7th, and 8th, New TV will blend movie, music, sitcom.
We gonna do it, and it's gonna be fun.
That's what my first wife said on our wedding night. What's wrong?
And cultural news to make one channel that's in a class by its own. New TV, fill it all over.
Go with that picture.
Free weekend, only on New TV.
The national leader in the production of African Americans at the undergraduate degree level. Florida A&M University offers 100 bachelor's, 20 master's, and 9 PhD degrees. FAMU is one of the first institutions of higher learning nationwide to bring a wireless computer network to its campus. With no more than a card slipped into a laptop, students can log on to the internet from any point on campus. We're innovators at FAMU. Wherever you want to go in life, FAMU has the programs, the opportunities, and environment to help you get there.
Welcome back to our game on MEAC College Football Saturday. Now it's time for the Greyhound Band Show. It's North Carolina A&T leads 21-10 over FAMU. Ladies and gentlemen, the world famous FAMU marching one band.
It's true.
Thank you.
When people perform together, extraordinary things can happen. Come see how 40,000 people of U.S. Airways are reorchestrating an airline around our customers. Because we know that your performance could be riding on ours.
Excuse me. You forgot your music.
Thank you.
Just playing my part.
U.S. Airways. Come visit us.
Is yours. Say goodbye to the slow torture of dial-up modems. Verizon Online DSL delivers the internet at light speed. With Verizon Online DSL, you have the power to enter the rich dynamic world of online sound and video without stumbling on the price. Call 1-800-638-5144 now. The power to talk and surf at the same time through a single existing home phone line. And you never need to dial up or wait to connect. Which means you can click onto the internet instantly. With Verizon Online DSL, the power is yours.
Verizon Online DSL, now with no startup costs and a free DSL modem, $99 value. Find out now if it's available to your home. Visit Verizon.com/DSL or call 1-800-638-5144.
For over 25 years, Jerry Ford in Annandale has been a recognized name associated with savings, selection, and service. At Jerry's, we've built our reputation by serving our local community. Now it's time for people from all over the metro area to experience Jerry's Fords. Our facility is most technologically advanced in the area. We've restored the enjoyment in making your purchasing experience pleasant and pressure-free. So when it's time to business, take your business to Jerry's Ford, where the only deal we can't make are the ones we don't see.
Live from Bragg Stadium in Tallahassee for the score, North Carolina A&T 21, FAMU 10. Guys, just spoke briefly with Coach Joe. He said the key, turnovers. We're killing ourselves. If that can cease, the Rattlers may be able to come back in it here in the second half. I look forward to an exciting second half. Back there is Tarani.
All right, Jeff, we appreciate Jeff Rumlin on the sideline doing a good job. And there he is, Coach Billy Hayes. He put it out there, 21-10. That is our score as we get ready for a third quarter and a second half of football that will provide plenty of excitement. Mark Ray?
He talked about mistakes did Coach Billy Joe. Three turnovers that led directly to all three A&T touchdowns. And in championship games like this one is, granted there's still a half a season to go, Bill Hayes has got to feel good that his one turnover really didn't come back to burn him, nor did his mental mistake. The one play where you had Quinn Gray get shoved out of bounds, that did cost A&T like 3 points. So it's effectively a new ball game, and that's why you play a second 30 minutes.
Darren Dawkins is our kicker to get us started in the second half of this football game for the Aggies. Lone receive is Isaac Brown. They're going to have to bring this one back at the 20-yard line.
So remember, at the end of the first half, we had a personal foul that was assessed. So obviously, it was against Florida A&M, and the Aggies were able to take full advantage of it. And I'm anxious to see right now, will Florida A&M's respect for the A&T defense continue to preclude them from going deep? As I said during halftime, I think that in order for them to get back into this game, they're going to have to make one big vertical passing play. And at that point, it may open some things up for the entire offense. And maybe, you know, the rumor downstairs right now is the confidence is wavering in Quinn Gray. We'll see if he can get it back together.
Quinn Gray, your quarterback, March Banks in the backfield. Give to March Banks. He turns the corner, but he's met by Massey and Little and the crew from A&T.
Well, you know, to me, that just plays in right into A&T's hands. You know, those big guys, that front seven or front eight, since they're running a 44 defensive scheme, they're right in there. And when you start going up against their A and B gaps, it's just almost impossible to consistently get big offensive yards.
When Gray keeping the football, the quarterback picks up about 8 yards on the play. Now, there's a difference in the center situation for the FAMU Rattlers. Mark, explain.
You're absolutely right. Early in the contest, Florida A&M lost their starting center, Terry Logan. He sprained his wrist. He is out for the rest of the game. In this direct snap situation, you see that one was high. There's a true freshman starting. And that pass goes awry. The freshman that we're talking about is Russell Brown,
Charles Allen was the intended receiver, so Brown is definitely Johnny on the spot, going against two aggressive inside linebackers. He's got to make those reads and those calls and those pickups, and this is a heck of a baptism under fire for a true freshman in a game of this magnitude against an aggressive and nasty defense.
And the offense all starts with the center. T.J. Smith is your kicker. Set to receive, Curtis DeLorch. This ball is going to drop around the 28-yard line. We've got a football game that will have tremendous magnitude at the end.
He's got Zagatron. I'll exchange it.
Introducing e-merchandise return from the United States Postal Service. It's so simple, your customers can print a prepaid return label right from your website. Now the stuff they buy online practically returns itself. Easier exchanges for them means more business for you. What's your e-priority?
Fly like an eagle.
Hey there, I'm for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Car Rental. Spend some time with national heroes. Or visit a national treasure. Or join the National Football League. But wherever you go, let National Car Rental get you there fast. With special low rates on minivans for only $229.99 per week nationwide. Or only $289.99 per week in New York. National Car Rental, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
To my sweetie Gladys, who has been my rock, I leave our home and all of my stocks and bonds.
Such a good provider.
To Melvin Jr., our family business and the Lincoln Continental.
I love you, Dad.
And to my young son, Trey, I leave you the one thing that brought us together. My Whitnauer.
The Whitnauer?
Yo, that's that, Pops.
Whitnauer, for fine watches, of course.
We're back live action, 21-10. North Carolina A&T with the lead. We're in the third quarter, and something's about to go off. Something's about to jump off in this game. I can feel the fever.
Can you feel it?
I can feel it.
Like Michael Jackson on the Triumph album, huh?
Hey, let's take a look at our target scoreboard, and as I do my little Michael Jackson impersonation.
Only Morgan a little State, bit of it.
Morgan State is leading Savannah State 12-0. That would be the Bears' first win of the season.
Got to protect the orange and blue, baby. Got to protect that orange and blue.
Hey, man, I can pay to do MEAC games. Howard is scoreless against Towson and Hampton 10. Norfolk State nothing. That's in the first quarter. Another battle of the Bay down there. We'll be at Norfolk State next week when they take on these very same FAMU Rattlers at home. Coach Mo Forte and the crew, and they've got some interesting individuals down there looking to see what Mr. Burnett and Mr. Smith can do on the offensive end, because John Roberts is a talented quarterback. And then, of course, the following week, we've got homecoming for the Aggies. Bethune-Cookman comes into town, and that means that Patel Troutman will be on the run against the North Carolina A&T Aggies. That's the 28th, so check your local listings for the times and when you can see the games on your MEAC College Football Saturday. What a huge crowd we've got going on right now, and we've got a player down. That's Dwayne Beverly, and we hope that he's okay. Number 58 on his back.
I get the feeling we're going to see a lot of people start dropping in the second half, because this is an extremely physical ball game. We saw Marcus Bryson for A&T hobble off after the previous play. So as you can see right now, this game ain't for the faint of heart. If you don't have that chin strap tightened just a little bit something, and those shoestrings laced up a little something, you could end up in this same kind of position right here.
We're going to come back with much more of the football action. We've got a young man down on the field. We wish him the very best. Much more MEAC College Football coming your way. 21-10, A&T with the lead.
That is so sweet.
Hey, here's your free phone for making the donation.
Want a free digital phone from Cellular One? Donate $20 to Special Olympics. Cellular One.
Family fun.
along with GMC and Pontiac Excitement.
Get it at Capital.
Our exciting new Aztec.
That's different as different can be.
A go-anywhere Jimmy.
Or a roomy Montana van.
A professional-grade truck that pulls and pulls.
At Capital, we have all kinds of vehicles.
That provide the gang with lots of fun.
We have a great selection.
At prices and payments that are really friendly.
Come see us.
Laburnum near the airport.
Or Southside, Route 60 Powhatan.
Capital Pontiac GMC.
An honest deal with never any hidden charges because
we care.
Travel Channel is brought to you by AT&T Broadband.
We got a player walking off the field, Dwayne Beverly, number 58. We're going to show you the injury as North Carolina A&T leads this game in the third quarter, 21-10. Mark, you see number 58 right there.
And it looks like he just got clipped by a big hip. And those knee joints are so fragile. Don't want to hazard a guess right now, but the way he's walking ever so gingerly, looks like he can't put a whole lot of pressure down. So it'll force battle to have to wait for a minute or so as Beverly gets off the field. And boy, it's a physical game.
Battle was completed just one pass on three attempts in the first half. That was an 8-yard strike, and that was for a touchdown to William Dominic. Dominic Williams.
You want to talk about somebody who's enjoying the action despite the score, but you talk about an economy of passing. You throw three passes and the one you complete for a touchdown, that's getting the job done.
Dominic Williams got it. 8-yard touchdown happened in the early part of this game. Jason Battle is your quarterback. Darius Helton was in motion.
Boy, that's
a Hicks. Hicks picks up 7.
That's just a play it looks like they took from their days when they were running primarily the wing T, where you just pull a couple of guards and just let them find the seam and watch them blast. Look at him. A little pull action. Almost some of that counter trade type stuff that you've been seeing in D.C. for a number of years and their big effective run play scheme in the NFL. And they do work that time. And, you know, still no answers yet by the FAMU front seven for the A&T running plays, and they've been using a couple of gaps, and now Florida A&M bunches up in there to try to take it away.
3rd and 1. And depending upon the spot, it could be a first down for the Aggies.
A&T's big nasties up front are like, we can move you, at will, and as we move you, our back, Maurice Hicks, will continue to pick up the yards and the first downs in this case. Let's take a look at Jerron Daly right here, who is one of those defensive ends that has been roaming throughout the formation all afternoon. And by Daly standards, he's been quite quiet as the Sporting News Division I AA preseason All-American.
1st and 10. Play action. Battle on the move. Battle finds Bryson. Maurice Bryson. And that's a first down for the big tight end.
Man, Ronnie, Anthony Nobles just cleaned the pursuit clock, which allowed Battle the opportunity to complete this pass. Let's watch this block. Watch number 76 bail his quarterback out. You'll see Burrows blasted, and that just opens it up for the tight end to catch the little waggle pass, and it is another Aggie first down.
Marcus Bryson, number 88, big tight end. They expect some great things from him. As a matter of fact, Coach Bill Hayes says he could be all conference if he puts his mind to it. Hicks still on the carry, moving his feet. Hicks is brought down. Carlos Moore on the tackle.
Boy, that's just a good job of pursuit that time. They just bunched it in right there, and the pursuit was drawn to Hicks. And leading the charge was Bynum that time. And we didn't hear a whole lot about Bynum coming in.
Oh, yes, we did.
But.
Oh, Bynum has done some great things for this football team this year. You know, a lot of times on defense, you look at numbers of tackles. Then you look at film and you find out they're running away from the individual. And that's why they're as good. In the I formation. Here we have it again. The Aggies. Hicks crossing the side. Hicks a first down. This young man continues to impress. Get out of his way. He's a bad man, Mr. Hicks.
Boy, but it's just an outstanding job up front by the big fellas who are just blasting Florida A&M a good 2 or 3 yards off the ball at the part of attack.
Definitely. Give credit where credit is due. The offensive line has done its job. But what I like is how this young man continues to run for extra yards. On that particular play, he picks up 4 himself by taking 2 defenders along with him.
And look at the Florida A&M defense right now. Guys with their hands on the hips already. And A&T is going to take a timeout, but it looks like in this war of attrition and the physical battle, maybe the big nasties up front are beginning to wear down on the smaller defense in front of Florida A&M just a little bit.
Have you ever had a crowd here at Bragg Stadium this quiet?
No.
Wow.
It's like an opera crowd.
Jeff Rumlin with an injury report. Jeff.
Guys, the injury report on linebacker Dwayne Beverly. Left sprained ankle. Family officials say his return is questionable. Back upstairs.
Jeff keeping us posted on the sidelines. Jeff Brumlin. We've had a host of great sideline reporters throughout our MEAC college football season. Jeff just being one of the very best. You see the score? 21-10. We're in the third quarter of this football game. Ronnie Duncan along with Mark Gray, play-by-play and color on our MEAC College Football Saturday Game of the Week. FAMU and North Carolina A&T. Adrian Parks. They keep bringing the names out. Adrian Parks is a young man who started the beginning of the season, number 28, for the Aggies. Then Hicks had his coming out party last week. 17 carries, 183 yards, and 2 touchdowns. And there he is, Adrian Parks, a young man who can definitely put up some big numbers, too.
But again, it goes back to the offensive front. I mean, if it's not the A gap, it's the B gap, and they're just wearing it out. There's nothing fancy. It doesn't take a brain surgeon to break this one down. It is just about smash-mouth football. I'm bigger than you. I'm stronger than you. I'm nastier than you. I'm going to dominate you. And that's what the A&T line is doing right now.
And once again, it's Bryson for the first down. When you have a huge target at 6'5", a tight end that is that good across the middle, he can hurt you. And this is great play action. Battle back the pass and finding Marcus Bryson.
But the play action works because you've been so effective at running the football up the middle that the guys are going to be drawn to that play. It freezes them, which allows Bryson to release. And the junior from Lawrence, South Carolina, has had 2 big catches on this drive. And once again, the Aggies are knocking on the door.
And they continue to mix it up. I formation for battle the give to Parks is finally brought down. That was Cola there, number 47. Parks gets maybe 1 yard on the play,
and they have to separate a couple of players right now, and you can see that the frustration is beginning to set in. Number 76 is Anthony Nobles, who had that big block on that previous pass completion to the tight end, who got involved in some a little bit of a fracas, shall we say, and it thankfully nobody gets tossed.
Dominic Williams is in the game. If you can recall the last time he was in the game in a situation like this, you saw that running back out of the backfield run for a touchdown. Well, not run for a touchdown, get one on the reception. Play action. And once again, it's Dominic.
Good call by you, Ronnie. I was looking for him out in the flat. If there's a little bit more touch on that pass, he's able to take it in. Little play action that's designed to hold the linebackers. But again, this is a bad pass, but a great catch. A twirling one-handed catch by Dominic Williams. Could he be the human highlight film of the MEAC? What a catch.
Yo, bro, I know that one was coming up soon. Matter of fact, when I was looking at his name, I was like, Dominic Wilkins. No, Dominic Williams.
Next time he scores a touchdown, maybe he does a 360 dunk over the goalpost or something.
All right, they've got 3 running backs in the game. And that time, Hicks is stopped.
And they do a good job of filling that gap that time with an explosion by the linebacker that sealed the gap.
Nikita Nyman, Bynum.
Bynum filling it that time. Boy, he's having a huge game. You talk about big players having to step up. Bynum is really stepping up on a day that has been not exactly the best day for the Florida A&M defense. And Hicks has now crossed the 2-century mark this afternoon.
You know, I told you he'd have a better game than the 183 he had last week. And the kick is up and good. And that was Darren Dawkins. We'll come right back. It's 24-10, North Carolina A&T with the lead over FAMU.
A friendly reminder to use your Target guest card. It's the only credit card that donates 1% of your purchase to the school of your choice. Use the Target guest card.
You ask him.
The only card that gives back to your favorite school.
All right, class. Today's lesson, saving money with Greyhound. Assume we get ourselves a Greyhound-friendly fare starting at just $49. And we use it to travel to thousands of places in the U.S. when we plan in advance. What do we save ourselves? Someone? Anyone?
A headache.
That's wrong. I can see we need more homework.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
A year ago, Coach Billy Joe won his 200th game against Hampton. We had it. Now, MEAC Game of the Week. Coach Billy Joe now with 210 wins for the FAMU Rattlers. He will go down in history as one of the best of all time. 24-10 is our score in the third quarter. 7:24 left to go in the third. And it is the Aggies leading the game. Mark?
And when you think in the annals of 1AA college football history in America, there is only one team in the nation who has won more games than Florida A&M. That would be Yale. Rattlers with 495 for their illustrious career.
Jaquay Nunley. Nunley brings the ball out to the 27-yard line, number 85 down. In the first half of this game, Nunley had 5 receptions for over 40 yards. How does Nunley get more involved in this offense? Now, I think 5 catches at halftime is a nice amount of catches.
It is a nice amount of catches, but they're not 5 Jaquay Nunley receptions where you get five receptions and he breaks them off for about 20 yards a pop.
Against Grambling last week, he only had 50 yards total receptions. He has had the catches, but maybe the numbers have not been there like they were. In the 90s, there was one team that dominated. Can you say Rattlers? 80 wins, just 39 defeats.
Let's be real for a second. I mean, there's only one win separating them and A&T, so I wouldn't quite call it domination. And as for Hampton, with all due respect to the folks down in the Virginia Bay, a lot of that work was done in CIAA.
Let me put it to you this way. When the Rattlers play football, you know about it. As you see, it is 24-10. They are trailing right now by 10 points in this game, but have you ever seen a Rattler score? They score so quickly. It's
right.
Like they strike real fast.
Right. And you know the venom is still there, which
it's
is
poison
why
in that offense.
I don't understand why they haven't tried. Exactly. And don't you ever do that again. But you got to understand, man, take a shot deep. Loosen up, A&T. And you talk about somebody that got loose. That was BJ. Well, actually, that was Ray Massey that time on a blitz. And he got loose, and there was some big-time help that time from Sammy Rogers and the intimidating brand of football that A&T has brought from Greensboro, and they are swaggering right now.
They are doing it in a reflection of their head coach. Bill Hayes is that kind of guy. Any team is truly a reflection of their head coach. That's Bill Hayes football, and he does not mind putting it in your face. Lloyd's trying to pick up the punt. And we're going to down that one at the 31-yard line.
A 3-and-out. Amazing. I'm just overwhelmed by the defensive performance of A&T right now.
MEAC College Football 2000 is produced by MyTeam.com Productions exclusively for the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference and its authorized outlets. Any use, reuse, or retransmission of this broadcast without the written consent of the MEAC Commissioner's Office is prohibited. That's MEAC College Football 2000.
Well, the ebb and flow of this game would almost dictate that a long 5-6-7 minute time-consuming drive really plays into the hands of A&T, and dare I say clock becomes an asset of the Aggies with the way they're running the football right now?
Most definitely. And when you're running the football, you're running time off the clock, and the time continues to roll. And that young man, over 200 yards unofficially on the day. Wow.
Well, when you start getting into the second half of the season, different players start stepping up. And this junior kind of turned the key on and the switch, much like the Yankees have done in the playoffs. He turned it on last week. And I'd suffice to say that he's probably around third gear right now. And showing the power as he's hit by Daly and carries it for a couple of yards like you've been talking about all game.
Daly is one of the best there is in college football, and look what Hicks does. He is consistent. He will drag you with him. That's a yard and a half.
And the quickness and the power of Daly to play off and then catch Hicks in pursuit. But again, this kid is big and powerful. And you talk about big, powerful kids. Jason Battle doing an excellent job of running the Aggie offense.
The containment of Daly has been huge today. I mean, here's a guy who can basically freelance if he wants, and that's a first down. Steve Shipp is the receiver.
A little slant pattern, safe pass. See, you keep banging on him, a body shot, body shot, body shot, then boom. Now watch it. They set him up with the body shot and then come right here, quick jab, bang. Little slant pattern, nothing fancy about it. Not asking your quarterback to make a deep, long-winded read. Not asking your offensive linemen to hold their assignments for a long time. The balance of the A&T offense right now has Florida A&M's defense really off balance.
Elton and North on the wide, and there it is. I think he might be going. And finally brought down by Daly. And that was Hicks with another huge run to bring the ball to the 26-yard.
I don't know what's more impressive, the fact that he was able to explode through that hole. Look at number one coming from the backside and going to go all the way downfield from his defensive end position to catch Hicks, who must be tiring a little bit right now. After taking shots, three long runs, he may have lost an engine out of those jets right now. But goodness knows, he's up around 230 yards right now. He has a right to be winded. And look at the big fella. The big fella, an offensive lineman at fullback.
And Adrian Fox is able to pick up 2 yards on the play.
I believe that's Talib Smith, who is the lead block. Shades of the refrigerator. Number 71 was the lead blocker as he runs off the field. That's quality stuff right there.
You know
there.
What? He enjoyed that. He said, did you see me? Man, I blasted him right back.
As big as that guy is, how can you not see him?
Adrian Parks in a lone backfield. Ship in motion. Play action, the give to North, and he goes nowhere because Cola and crew were right there to stop it. Cedric Bird also in on the tackle for the Rattlers.
Well, when you've been just going straight up and blasting people, no sense in getting any fancy. No sense in getting jiggy with it, if you will. You might as well just keep going and going. And Daly is just having a relentless ball game. Not exactly the dominant player that he can be, but he is all over the place. And I tell you something, he won't play defensive line on the next level, but he may have the quickness to play linebacker, certainly outside on Sundays.
On everybody's preseason All-American list, Battle looking back to pass, getting flushed out of the pocket. Battle got rid of it. Incomplete.
The Aggie fans want intentional grounding, but there was a receiver in that general vicinity, and out there in the flat was Ian Aylstock. Tremendous job by Battle in this situation to avoid the sack.
Well, watch this, Nikita Bynum. You see him? Number 52. We've talked about him throughout the entire day, and also Cedric Bird. Two players who continue to put the pressure on the Aggies.
Boy, this
Another
could
field goal attempt. Darren Dawkins.
This could make it a three-score game, and the way the A&T defense is playing right now, this is huge.
41-yard attempt. The kick is up. And it's good. Can you believe what we're seeing right now? Bill Hayes has brought all of the stops out in this one. It is 27-10, North Carolina A&T. A year ago, when I heard about this final score, that the Aggies had beaten the Rattlers, I was shocked. No need to be shocked. They've got the Rattlers' numbers.
I don't know if Bill Hayes has a recipe for perfection in his office in Greensboro, but he could not have drawn up a better afternoon in a game of this magnitude for his team. Offensive line, in my opinion, has been the story of the game, which has allowed Hicks to step up and perform tremendously. And you look at the job that they're doing defensively, stopping the run. They've clamped down and made the adjustment. They've taken away the run after the catchability of the receivers, and they have made today effectively a living hell for Quinn Gray right now. This has been a textbook performance on all fronts to this point by North Carolina A&T. But I'm wondering, now Florida A&M has nothing to lose, then let's go deep.
Play selection has been very impressive for one team and maybe not the best for others. 31 rushes, 9 pass attempts, and look at that, pretty even out at the bottom list.
But you're running that much because they haven't stopped you. And this is Nunley.
Nunley to the 27-yard line.
Well, we've only seen him attack vertically once.
know, he says he's happier than he's ever been.
Caliber defense, Ronnie.
Yeah, it is.
This is a defense that can win it all.
You got to wonder whether or not if they're pitted against a Youngstown State in the very first round.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me welcome you back. No, this wasn't Heidi Bowl 2000, MEAC style, but we lost power. And without power, we're nothing, but we are back because the power gods have decided to give us more juice. And that's Sammy Rogers.
That's Quinn Gray who fumbled. I believe that's a fumble, Ronnie.
Yeah, that was Sammy Rogers back there to get him, too. Number 41 for the Aggies, that swarming defense. It is still 30-10, the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. With the lead, and Quinn Gray wishes this was another day. Man, this blue depth defense has been destroying the Rattlers all day long.
You know, Ronnie, this was a situation coming in. Florida A&M's offense was ranked number one in the MEAC, averaging over 440 yards a game. They were tops in pass offense, averaging around 283, tops in scoring offense at about 42 points. Meanwhile, you talk about imposing your will on a game. That is what the Aggies defense has done. And now Jason Battle can just lead his team for another 13 minutes to victory.
And Jason Battle was looking for Ship. Pass incomplete. Vickers, Darnell Vickers there. 30-10 in the fourth quarter. That's our score right now. And it has been a game of domination. Now, the flip side to that, you gave me all those great offensive numbers for FAMU, but what about the flip side for North Carolina A&T?
Well, their defense came in to this contest. They were tops in the MEAC, averaging only giving up about 194 yards a game. Their pass defense was only giving up about 76 yards per game. And their scoring defense is only giving up 8 points. And it's pretty much been a textbook afternoon for A&T. I've been very impressed with the pressure that they've been able to get up front. But their downfield coverage has been as even more impressive as their downfield blocking on offense.
Let me explain once again for many of you who are joining us. We took a power hit. And basically, we had to try very hard to get back on the air. But the engineers with MyTeam.com and the staff of the MEAC engineering crew got us back on the air. And just like the band, we've got the power one more time. And we've got the juice one more time. And we're about to let loose on MEAC College Football Saturday.
Talk about letting loose that time. Hoo-hoo-hoo-wee. There were some people that were in the snap count or in the North Carolina A&T huddle that time.
That's Mr. Aylstock on the carry, number 26 for the Aggies, a name that we heard so much about prior to this game. He had 74 yards, Mark, in a game against Morgan State last week, and so far hadn't heard from him. Once again, another field goal attempt by the Aggies. Darian Dawkins. And it's no good.
So about the only thing that hasn't gone well for the Aggies this afternoon, but when you're up by 20, Ronnie, it really doesn't matter. A&T 30, A&M 10.
Verizon Online DSL delivers the internet at lightning speed. With Verizon Online DSL, you have the power to leap into the rich dynamic world of online sound and video without stumbling on the price. Call 1-800-638-5144 now. You have the power to talk and surf at the same time through a single existing home phone line. And you never need to dial up or wait to connect. Which means you can click onto the internet instantly. With Verizon Online DSL, the power is yours.
Verizon Online DSL, now with no startup costs and a free DSL modem, a $99 value. Find out now if it's available to your home. Visit Verizon.com/DSL or call 1-800-638-5144.
We're back via College Football Saturday, North Carolina A&T 30, FAMU 10, and there has been a quarterback change. Quinn Gray, the starting quarterback for FAMU this season, has been replaced by number 13, J.J. Joe Jackson.
A lefty who's got a big-time arm. It looked like he was pretty accurate on that previous pass, and you really got to start wondering about the confidence of Quinn Gray after a couple of subpar performances in two big games. Certainly this one, you got to start wondering whether or not those demons are starting to creep in between his ears.
He's got to be concerned about it. I mean, this young man, Jackson, comes into the game a week ago. It was an automatic first down. I think it was a late hit on the quarterback. So that looks good for FAMU, and you never know. I mean, there's plenty of time on the clock. There's 11:22 left to go in this football game, and if Mr. Jackson can become Action Jackson, maybe the Rattlers can get back into a game that North Carolina A&T has dominated. Jackson in the shotgun formation. He's a tall, slender-built quarterback, not as strong-looking, but the arm can deceive you. This young man, a lefty, can let it go. And there he is, Jackson, still on his feet, being pursued. He throws the ball up. And the reason why, there was nothing but heat by Mr. Relaford coming from the Aggies of North Carolina A&T, number 92, Leonard Relaford.
Well, we talked about B.J. Massey and, Ray Massey and B.J. Little being terrors, the beast at the linebacker position, but Relaford is a force in his own right, and he was one of the reasons that Quinn Gray is taking an early spot on the bench. Relentless pressure all game by the Aggies front eight.
Coming out of the pocket, Jackson showing off his arm, looking for the intended receiver, Isaac Brown, and he is very fortunate because it could have been picked off by the Aggies, and there was Deloach.
That's right. Deloach does a good job in coverage, but Relaford was held a couple times on that particular play, which is why he doesn't get the sack. Good job of field generalship by Jackson, the quarterback, to get away from the pressure and deliver a strike, and good coverage by the D-backs. And Aggies on another blitz.
Third and 10, but March Bright with it, and he might have enough for a first down, Mark.
Looks like he picked it up. Now I'm anxious to see about the pacing of the Florida A&M offense right now. They opened the season that we saw them in Dover, you know, with a bit of a fast break. They slowed down a count or two, a half a step in this particular contest, and it might have played into the Aggies' hands.
Joe Jackson out of the shotgun, a little juggling there, and that was Jacquay Nutley! Woo! And that was almost picked up and caught by Isaac Brown. Nunley had it, lost it. Brown almost picked it up again.
Here is your preseason tip drill coming to fruition in the middle of the season. Tip, I got it. I don't want it. Oh, almost looked like the Olympic volleyball competition. It was digging somebody, setting up for a spike.
Remind me of Hot Potato, Walbrook Junction, back in the day at a schoolyard. There he is, Nunley on the reception. Jacquay Nunley, first down. Nunley still on his feet, spinning inside the 30.
Yeah, but we're going to have a penalty. And the way that the A&T defenders are celebrating, I think it's going against Florida A&M. Might be an illegal block in the back or somebody releasing deep downfield after that play was set up. And there's DeLaundre on the turf. Your illegal block in the back. It has been just a day of errors for Florida A&M. Mistakes have repeatedly killed them. Even in the earlier stages of the game, when the game was close, they were moving, doing positive things offensively, penalties, turnovers, good reads and bad passes.
Yeah, an illegal push in the back against the offense. 10 yards, repeat, second down.
Let's take a look at the block in the back coming up right here. It looks like, was that DeMar Bowe that time? Check that, Wayman White got a block in the back to Spring Nutley for about another 15 yards, and that's about how much it costs Florida A&M.
That's the North Carolina A&T band. They've got a lot to celebrate about, leading this game 13-10. Nunley again on a reception. Nunley for a first down.
Well, that's what he does, goes across the middle. You know, he'll probably be talking about it around here during the course of the next week. Give me the ball. And he has had his touches, but give North Carolina A&T credit. They have done a good job in containing the Florida A&M receivers. You know, the Gulf Coast offenses, three-step drops, timing patterns, read, react quickly, and then let the receivers take advantage of their individual ability. And North Carolina A&T just ain't having it today.
Jackson has been impressive. Ball at 35-yard line, first and 10. Jackson again finds the receiver. T.J. Hines, and the pass is ruled incomplete.
Boy, there was some blitzing coming on off the corner. Montrell Pittman was bearing down on the quarterback, and I think it forced Jackson to let that pass go a little early. He probably wanted to hold it for a half a count, maybe a count later, and then deliver it into the flat, but it was to no avail.
Second and 10 from the 35-yard line. Jackson out of the shotgun. He pumps. Jackson brought down. Sammy Rogers in the backfield. He's there.
Rogers is awesome. I mean, unbelievable. This guy plays off a block. Watch him. Coming from the far side. Look at the battle that's going on between he and Marchbanks. And he plays off Marchbanks and then picks up Jackson and hauls him to the turf. Wow. I mean, is this like an all-star defense or something? And not only seven catches, but a quiet 59 yards.
Jackson's got to sling that one. Charles Allen made the reception.
And he's checking himself for whiplash after that lick.
And Bailey got him back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, check your faculties, Mr. Allen. You just almost
that'll
got
make it fourth down and 11. And you know Jackson is going to put his arm in action on this one. Out of the shotgun formation. Four wide receivers. Hines in motion. Jacque Nunley. No, it was intended for Isaac Brown. Little Isaac Brown was there. However, defending for the Aggies was the Larch.
Well, you know something? There's an old saying. Gremlins, old former head coach Eddie Robinson used to talk about it. Pressure will bust a pipe. And that time, the pressure doesn't get to the quarterback, but it forced him to release a pass that was bad, and it had nothing to do but the relentless pressure bearing down on him, and that's why that play wasn't completed. And now North Carolina A&T is basically trying to just pick up about three first downs and just take the air out of the football. It's a very impressive performance that we've seen, and I'm just thinking today, this may be the ultimate jinx, Ronnie, but we may have seen a national championship caliber defense wearing blue and gold today.
Well, A&T coming to the game was 2-0 in the conference. It appears they will move up to 3-0 overall. In the conference, that is. The overall record will turn to 5-1. A&T has only lost one game this season. And that was a game in which their offense could not find a way onto the scoreboard.
You're absolutely right. And it was also against an Elon team that plays wishbone. And when you don't see a wishbone, it's hard to prepare for it. This is just battle taking it to the outside and doing what he does and just holding on to the rock, keeping the clock moving and just directing a solid game plan. And this,
you know, it's amazing to me how A&T has regrouped and reloaded. I mean, they lost, in my opinion, the best back in the MEAC last season, Amari Smith, who is now playing with the Atlanta Falcons, number 43.
Right.
There were several games we had last season where Amari Smith simply came into the game and took it over. But when you have a good program, and all you have to do is look at the list of the players on North Carolina A&T, where they have gone to school, where they've come from, and you can see that North Carolina A&T is able to recruit worldwide, not just statewide, and I do mean worldwide. They're able to get some of the best kids out there in North Carolina who want to play for Coach Bill Hayes. And it's a testament to his coaching staff and the commitment to athletics by the athletic director at North Carolina A&T.
Yes, indeed. Dr. Alfonso Scandrett has to be extremely proud of the performance his team coming down into Tallahassee is performing today. And you're looking at two teams right here whose bar has been raised. They compete for things other than just bragging rights in the conference. And this is a very impressive performance. And I think when we look back in about a month, 4 weeks from now, we'll look at this being a defining moment for both of these teams. Now North Carolina A&T has got to feel confident that if they continue to perform this well and can run the table for the balance of the season, they could host at least one 1AA playoff game. And that's going to be a tough place for anybody from outside this league to go into and win.
You know, they've got a facility in which they put a lot of money into. You see cheerleaders, of course, having themselves a good time. It's going to be a nice way home back to North Carolina A&T. We'll come back with much more of this game. 30-10, A&T leads.
Travel provided by U.S. Airways. U.S. Airways and U.S. Airways Express offer over 4,600 flights a day to more than 250 cities throughout the U.S., Canada, the Caribbean, and Europe. Fly U.S. Airways.
To my sweetie Gladys, who has been my rock, I leave our home and all of my stocks and bonds.
Such a good provider.
To Melvin Jr., our family business, and the Lincoln Continental.
I love you, Dad.
And to my younger son, Trey, I leave you the one thing that brought us together. My Wittenauer.
The Wittenauer? Yo, that's fat, Pops.
Wittenauer for fine watches, of course.
What you've been fortunate to achieve in life, it's important to share that success with others. I feel strongly about that. I believe the folks at Target stores do too. And they talked to me about kids fighting cancer at the St. Jude Children's Research Hospital and the idea of building a place for families to stay. I knew it needed to happen. Today, Target House is real. It's a success story from a store that donates over $1 million a week back to the community. Sharing success is something I admire.
Travel provided by U.S. Airways, offering the Dividend Miles program with preferred levels of membership and benefits. With U.S. Airways, you can redeem your miles to over 500 destinations worldwide.
FAMU has a rich tradition. Back in 1954, Althea Gripson graduated from FAMU. She went on in 1957 to win Wimbledon and the U.S. Open titles. A proud graduate of FAMU. The legendary great Althea Gibson. And there's our score, 30-10, and those young FAMU fans are saying, I've never seen stuff like this before. Last time FAMU was held to 10 points with back-to-back games was 1987. They scored just 10 points last week at the Circle City Classic, losing to Grambling 12-10, and right now they might fall victim scoring just 10 points against the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. All start on the carry, but he's brought down. And a host of guys, of course, leading the way, Jerron Daly. Daly's mom is here with him today. A lot of the seniors had their parents on Parents' Day, introduced them to the crowd, talked about their majors. This is a fine institution. And the one thing you can expect about FAMU is that not only do you play good football here, you get a quality education as well.
Well, one thing about it, if parents are in this building, and their parents are Florida A&M kids, there's some kids going to be grounded for a little while after this performance. Take away the key to the car, leave them in their room without supper, all of that.
Aggie's funny. As it ground, and that ball will be down at the 12-yard line.
Author of one of those few defining plays that worked for Florida A&M this afternoon. It's all A&T in Tallahassee. Back at you in a minute.
When people perform together, extraordinary things can happen. Come see how the 40,000 people of U.S. Airways are reorchestrating an airline around our customers. Because we know that your performance could be riding on ours.
Excuse me. You forgot your music.
Thank you.
Just play my part.
U.S. Airways, come visit us.
Brought to you by AT&T Broadband.
Family fun along with GMC and Pontiac Excitement.
Get it at Capital.
our exciting new Aztec.
That's different as different can be.
A go-anywhere Jimmy.
Or a roomy Montana van.
A professional-grade truck that pulls and pulls.
At Capital, we have all kinds of vehicles.
That provide the gang with lots of fun.
We have a great selection.
At prices and payments that are really friendly.
Come see us.
Laburnum near the airport.
Or Southside, Route 60 Powhatan.
Capital Pontiac GMC.
An honest deal with never any hidden charges because
we care.
We're back, 30-10, North Carolina A&T with the lead. Under 5 minutes of play in this game, and we almost had a safety. Jacque Nunley and company was able to at least gain some yards, but not enough, forcing the Rattlers into another punting situation.
Well,
I don't think there has been these many punting situations for a FAMU team in years, buddy. Boy, not here at this stadium.
It's almost like the first half of last week's game revisited. What do we have, 17 punts in the first half or something ridiculous like that in Norfolk?
Hey, we set a record, though.
Oh, yeah. And what is that they say about records? They're made to be broken. So now the Aggies have a four corners football offense. You will see it right now. And you know, today is a most illustrious day. Remember the good old days? Remember the days when you were a young fella just breaking into the business, Mr. Duncan, when you were looking for yourself, hoping to discover and find the true inner you? When you were trying to get your points across, when you were struggling to get out of the bed in the morning? The way it was October 14th, 1958, of course, you were born BC before cable, and without cable, there could be no MEAC TV. Oh, you ain't seen nothing yet. Okay. I believe that's Matkins in the lineup.
Yeah, Matkins is the quarterback looking for Helton.
And, of course, you were born before, and of course, in 1958, there was no MEAC. The teams in the MEAC were playing in the SIAC and the CIAA. And then, of course, the Baltimore Colts, your favorite football team, were in Baltimore. There weren't these godforsaken Ravens and
Indianapolis.
You know, think about it.
Okay.
PSINet Stadium rightly should be Peyton Place. And then, of course, the Browns ruled Cleveland, not Tim Couch. It was the Cleveland Browns of Otto Graham and Paul Brown playing in the Mistake on the Lake, not Tim Couch playing in that new building. And, of course, there was no Mark Gray. I don't even think my parents began courting at that time. So happy birthday, Mr. Duncan. You don't look a day over 42.
Oh, man. You know, thanks a lot. I'm getting you, boy. I'm busting your behind after this game. It's on. You hear me? Thanks a lot, Mark.
Happy birthday, man.
Hey, thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Anything exciting planned?
I just want to get back home to the family and kids, man.
And the snow, right?
And enjoy it. It's no snow in Cleveland right now.
Okay.
There isn't any snow in Cleveland.
It's just cold, huh?
Yeah, it's just cold. But not that cold. Let's get back to the game.
Boy, Daly came on unabated on a blitz with a little help from Cola, and Matkins was really introduced to this game.
Jeremy Banks was there, too. And once again, every time you turn around, they just can't wait to get out of the door. I'm talking about the Aggies of North Carolina A&T.
Daly's still hurt.
Because of the simple fact that they just want to go home and celebrate. Daly is still hurt. He's still on the sidelines, still in the backfield. And this could be a serious blow for future games.
Such as next week.
Yes.
We've got Florida A&M next week.
You know, A&M won 10 games last season, but they lost 4 games.
Mm-hmm.
And they're a team that has been known to come back. Let's face it. I mean, you saw what happened last season. We'll talk more about it. We've got more of the game. 30-10, North Carolina A&T with the lead.
Hey there. Time for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Car Rental. Spend some time with national heroes. Or visit a national treasure. Or join the National Football League. But wherever you go, let National Car Rental get you there fast. With special low rates on minivans for only $229.99 per week nationwide. Or only $289.99 per week in New York. National Car Rental, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
Yeah.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
You've always trusted us with your letters, your bills, your packages. Now, we're bringing the security and confidence of the real world into the virtual one. Introducing the U.S. Postal Service's e-bill pay. Enroll now to receive, pay, and send your bills online with the service you already know and trust.
Fly like an eagle.
Surprise, surprise, and we're not talking Goma Powell. I'm talking about the North Carolina A&T Aggies, 30-10, leading FAMU and on their way to victory. And one of the reasons why that young man, Mr. Hicks.
Yeah, he certainly is representing them. All your boys and the family back in the Carolinas, they owe you big-time props, Mr. Hicks. I can't wait to see you in a couple of weeks on homecoming.
Isaac Brown, turning things around. But Brown is finally brought down. So who are our players of the game? Who takes those top honors? Who do we go with?
I think we probably do have to go with Mr. Maurice Hicks for North Carolina A&T. You talk about a guy who's been the scintillating performer on this afternoon. You definitely have to consider Hicks. And, of course, on the other side of the ball, I'll go with Anthony Cola. I mean, you're talking about a linebacker who was relentless. He did a great job in pass coverage, getting pressure on the quarterback and in run support. He had a complete defensive performance. Trouble is, there wasn't enough of them to go around. If there had been 11 Anthony Colas, then maybe Maurice Hicks only gets, say, 125 yards.
How about that? Marine players of the game. Hicks and Cola. MEAC College Football Saturday. Next week, we'll see the Rattlers again, but this time they'll be taking on Norfolk State, who, by the way, was losing at halftime to Hampton. Major League hadn't even scored a point.
Set the over-under on that one. Florida A&M is going to be a little testy, ornery, having lost a couple of games in a row, going against a team that has offensive woes. I'd say probably FAMU in 40.
I'd say FAMU by a whole lot, and 40 will do just fine with me. T.J. Hines on the reception. This young man is becoming a possession receiver for the Rattlers. 3 minutes left to go in the game. And I think our sideline reporter is going to have some work to do. He's going to be talking to a lot of the Rattlers, a lot of the Aggies after this game.
Well, apparently Bill Hayes' is game face, and was there a fumble? No, there wasn't. There was a just a good defensive play once again. But in looking at next week's contest, you know, we saw that defense is not the issue. Today's score notwithstanding, as far as Hampton is concerned, last week with Norfolk State, Florida A&M does throw the ball a lot better than we've seen today. And the Achilles heel at Norfolk for the Spartans defense is their secondary. So their front seven is going to have to steal a bunch of the schemes that A&T used if they're going to at least stay in the game with Florida A&M next week.
All right, there's been timeout on the field. I can tell you right now that there are two scores that we can report on from the MEAC today. In the third quarter, it is Hampton 26, Norfolk nothing. And at halftime, Towson State leads Howard 24-6. Steve Wilson's crew has not been getting off the way they would like to, and that's got to be a situation for fans in the nation's capital as to why aren't we winning football games.
You know something? Every once in a while, you know, we talked about this in D.C. a few weeks ago. Every once in a while, coaches reach a point with their teams or their programs where they're not reaching their players anymore. I think Steve Wilson is in that position right now, and I don't know if the players have turned him off or the controversy surrounding the athletic program at Howard is beginning to seep its way into the football program, but there's too much talent on that football team for them to be laboring at the bottom of
especially
the conference.
When you've got a Jermaine Hutchinson and Townsend throwing the football.
But that's one of the things. Townsend, half the time he's at quarterback, the other half he's at receiver. How can he get into a rhythm? Now see, there's somebody looking to pad their stats right there, Ronnie. Curtis DeLoach just wanted to make sure he got on the offensive side of the ledger today.
Did you think it would be this type of an outcome? Mm-mm. Especially when you consider these two teams.
Ooh,
obviously,
sir.
You knew that the Blue Death defense would be huge. 30-10 is our score. We'll come back with much more.
What you've been fortunate to achieve in life, it's important to share that success with others. I feel strongly about that. I believe the folks at Target stores do too. When they talked to me about kids fighting cancer at the St. Jude Children's Research Hospital and the idea of building a place for families to stay, I knew it needed to happen. Today, Target House is real. It's a success story from a store that donates over $1 million a week back to the community. Sharing success is something I admire.
It's just a bat and a ball. It's just a stick and some ice. It's just a Saturday morning. Just a bunch of players, parents, coaches, and fans coming together in a whole new way online for team schedules, team messages, team spirit. MyTeam.com. Enjoy the game.
Remember college?
I bet you do.
I bet you do.
Remember the highs, the lows,
the pressure,
the party?
Are you kidding me? You're going to risk your hard-earned cash?
Take food off your table?
Off your table?
Betting on 18-year-old
kids? You might as well.
Throw your money away.
Fool.
Fool.
So watch our games for this kind of
this action. This kind of action.
Not this.
Not this.
Because if you're banking on me
to make your day,
don't
bet on it. Don't bet on it.
MEAC College Football Saturdays 2000 is sponsored in part by USPS, Nike, Xerox, Target, Coca-Cola, U.S. Marine Corps, New Urban Entertainment, Greyhound, Wittenauer, National Car Rental, and U.S. Airways.
So who would have thunk it? Yes, right. You're Superman. You're the Man of Steel. Because
there he is right there, too, number 22.
30-10. You know what? There was a power outage here, but I believe that power outage went far beyond just taking us off the air. I think it took the offense out of FAMU, too.
How about that? Over the last two contests in this storied MEAC rivalry, North Carolina A&T has now outscored Florida A&M over the last, I guess we can say now, full eight quarters between the two, 60-25. If there was a disparity between those two teams over the course of two games, one would assume Florida A&M would have been the one opening up the can, right? Amazing. I mean, you get evenly matched teams, heated rivals, great deals of respect by the coaching staff and the players, and it's... This is just an unfathomable occurrence.
It's been a great situation for Coach Bill Hayes. Once again,
padding the stats are the Aggies.
The Aggies continue to roll, and the personnel continues to come out of nowhere. Cornelius Gary, that's who it was on the run. And he's been dying to get some playing time. And he said, Coach, see what I can do? You got to play me more.
And people around will say that Bill Hayes is trying to run up the score. Nah, that's just like a third string running back finally getting some playing time and trying to move up on the depth chart.
The sophomore from Bailey, North Carolina, finally got his number called, and he's a happy man for it. Damian Phillips is in the game at the quarterback duties.
Big props to our sports information director for hooking us up with the information that we needed all day. Of course, Donald Hunt, the outstanding outstanding sports information director at North Carolina A&T. And thanks as always to Alvin Hollins for hosting us here at Florida A&M, for keeping us going despite the power failure that hit the campus and the offense today.
We'll get a chance to hear the FAMU marching 100 after the game. And, of course, we will have some post-game sound. Jeff Brumlin is our man on the sideline, and I'm sure Jeff will be there to make sure he gets all of the action. It's over. It's 30-10. North Carolina A&T has come into the hostile territory of Tallahassee, Florida, and they have beaten the Rattlers in their house. And this game will have some huge indications as to who will win the MEAC this year. And right now, they are still undefeated. So you have three teams in the MEAC that are still undefeated as we speak, Bethune-Cookman, Hampton, and North Carolina A&T. And a lot of people are wondering whether A&T holds the big bragging rights in all of this.
Well, they certainly do. And these two victories have been dominant victories by North Carolina A&T over Florida A&M.
It's one thing to do it at home, and they did it at home in Greensboro last year. But to do it here, a game that soon as they marked it down, October 14th, they knew this was countdown to the showdown. This was the real nitty-gritty. This is a game that you put everything on the line. And FAMU falls at home.
Well, we've got one more ceremonious play.
And that's just for TV, I would imagine.
Quiet as a skept, guys. We don't want it.
That's okay. We'll take it. And they'll just fall to one knee, and that will be the end of the game.
I don't know how much time is supposed to be remaining, but you'd hate to see something out of the ordinary happen that cost somebody a season for a meaningless play. That'll ice it. So now we are officially over. So Florida A&M drops their first conference game of the season, Ronnie. And of course, North Carolina A&T clearly in the driver's seat as far as the conference race is concerned. They've got big matchups at home coming up. The toughest remaining games on their schedule are at their crib. When you look at Bethune-Cookman coming into Aggieland next week, in 2 weeks, as we'll have here on MEAC College Football Saturday. And then they end the season against Hampton at home. Both of those are in Aggie Stadium. I think they got out of here, and this is this may be the victory that springboards them into another perfect season in the MEAC. They could run the table and go 22-0 over two seasons.
All right, final score once again, 30-10. It was all about the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. We'll have more in a moment from Tallahassee.
Impressions are important. What you drive says a lot about who you are. Make a statement. Choose a quality pre-owned luxury vehicle from Select Auto Imports. Our new expanded facility features a grand selection of carefully screened, gently used, immaculate motor cars. Make your statement. Come experience for yourself the selection of luxury, the luxury of Select.
Brought to you by AT&T Broadband.
Victorious day for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T, winning 30-10 over FAMU in their house. One of the reasons why, Mr. Hicks, with him, Mr. Rumblin.
Maurice Hicks, over 200 yards rushing. You came in today. A little bit of an attitude game here versus Florida A&M, rather.
Everything started, the big play the defense made down at the goal line that really turned everything over. The offensive line really did an outstanding job, receivers, blocking. I mean, I ain't have no problems getting through the holes and nothing. I mean, we just came down here as everybody always underdoubting us, and we came out here and did our thing.
Last year you went 8-0, undefeated in MEAC play. Do you feel that this year another 8-0 performance is on the way?
Yes, definitely. I didn't play with A&T last year, but I definitely think that we're going to do the same.
Mr. Hicks, congratulations. Good luck on the rest of the season.
All right.
Guys, back up to you.
Maurice Hicks, a guy who came through with some huge numbers. Now it's time for the best post-game show around. It is the world-famous FAMU Marching 100 Band. you've just heard from the FAMU Marching 100 Band. We've got more coming up, highlights and a review. It was A&T winning 30-10.
At this time, this is the FAMU Marching 100 Green Band, which will provide...
It's just a bat and a ball. It's just a stick and some ice. It's just a Saturday morning. Just a bunch of players, parents, coaches, and fans coming together in a whole new way online for team schedules, team messages, team spirit. MyTeam.com. Enjoy the game.
He's got Zagatron. I'll exchange it.
Introducing e-merchandise return from the United States Postal Service. It's so simple, your customers can print a prepaid return label right from your website. Now the stuff they buy online practically returns itself. Easier exchanges for them means more business for you. What's your e-priority?
Fly like an eagle.
Just a friendly reminder to use your Target guest card. It's the only credit card that donates 1% of your purchase to the school of your choice. Use the Target guest card.
You ask it.
The only card that gives back to your favorite school.
We're back. It was a total game of domination. A defense that didn't let up. North Carolina A&T wins it 30-10 over the Rattlers of FAMU. And did we have some highlights and stats to show you? Of course we do, because we had the best game around in Tallahassee. Here's our Xerox final stats, and when you talk about total rushing yards, wow, 274 for the Aggies and 28 for FAMU, Mark.
And that's the story in the game. When you're able to dominate at the point of attack through the A and the B gaps, which is what Maurice Hicks was running through for the most of the time in the game, where he was doing his fantastic work. I mean, there, I am so impressed with the offensive front and the front eight of A&T. I'm telling you something, they have definitely woken up my eyes, and I got to believe that this team is going to get better as the season goes on.
The big key in those Xerox stats has to be the turnovers. FAMU turning over the ball four times, and of course three of those times turned into touchdowns for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. Let's take a look at our highlights of this game, because the young man who was so big in the highlights has to be Maurice Hicks. 24 carries, 236 yards, two touchdowns, his longest run for 60 yards, and that was an opening for everyone to see that this young man was going to have one heck of a game. A week ago against Morgan State University, he carried the ball 17 times, had two touchdowns for 183 yards. This week, he surpasses that and even has a better game, 236 yards. He was a pleasure to watch, number 22, Maurice Hicks.
Well, this is a kid who just, frankly, when they needed somebody to step up in a critical situation, he was there. And now we'll go to the highlights and take a look at just what kind of work that he was doing. Well, it started with Florida A&M trying to push their way in, and they were given a touchdown. That was the only time they would lead. Hicks got it going here. This is a 60-yard scamper where he got tremendous downfield blocking and took it to the house.
That was his 35-yard touchdown run. And then once again, it's nothing but, of course, passing the football and finding people. And that, of course, with the North Carolina A&T touchdown. That was Dominique Williams, 8 yards from Jason Battle. And Jason Battle only threw the ball 10 times and completed 5 passes for 50 yards.
But then Hicks was able to take another Florida A&M turnover and make them pay. He got tremendous downfield blocking once again, and he gave credit to his offensive line and the downfield blocking that he was getting. The line opened the holes. He went through the holes when he got downfield and needed critical blocks. It was a total team effort this afternoon.
Once again, Darren Dawkins had 3 field goals, the last 3 scores for North Carolina A&T. Field goals of 17, 32, and 17 yards. It was North Carolina A&T winning, staying undefeated in the MEAC, winning 30-10.